funny to bring in. I forgot my fucking MacBook. I was gonna start it off with some music, but shit, just press record and then I got you.
All right, cool.
Improvise. Cool, play some music.
20 seconds.
20 seconds.
20 seconds to launch.
20 seconds until I'm on. Tell your girl. Just follow it.
There's a lot of quieter energy over here. Right. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. It's my jam right now.
Oh, shit.
I talk about this over here. It's grown folk music, but you know, I just want to educate y'all a little bit.
How grown are you?
I've got facial hair.
What age are you showing right now?
I'm saying I got 60-year-old energy right now.
Oh shit. That boy old. No, he matured. He drinking wine.
I'm saying.
Push the fucking pack off of the porch or break a pound down. Get the scrap if it happen to blow, it makes a round sounds. Pussy cat on my lap, push it back and go to town. Now I'm putting rap on my back and I'm black and snatching crowns. I came back around like a nigga selling crack and pounds. I got a bag now, but it's nothing to brag about. Gun blast in the back.
Sorry, I had to bring this over here.
Sorry.
Ladies and gentlemen,
ignorant.
We are on the No Name Podcast at the moment.
Because motherfuckers,
take it away.
No, because motherfuckers want to sit here like they in a therapy session right now.
He's got some issues. Talk to him.
I'm trying to see
how help him out.
Yeah. Well, all right. Come on. We're gonna start it off. What are you going through, sir?
A lot, bro.
Let's talk about it. What's number one?
A lot, bro. Life.
Life.
Always number one, bro.
All right. So what aspects, man? What's going on? Why are you sitting here like you laying down, you getting comfortable?
Yeah, I'm going through a lot, man. So I felt like as soon as I was entering this space.
Well, what you going through? Life doesn't, everybody's going through. I'm going through life.
What are you going through? Let's start by breaking the ice there.
I'm not going through anything.
Never seen like a patient be the, right. That's awesome. That's good. That's good.
Yeah. Ask back. What are you going through? Sir, I don't think it works like that.
Maybe I'm defensive and I'm just like protecting myself.
I don't know how to break those walls down, sir.
Maybe you don't need to break the walls down.
Fair enough.
What's going on with you, fam?
You know, just floating in this atmosphere we call Earth. Just, you know, going with the motions. You feel me? What's going on with you, man?
Not a whole lot, man. There's a whole lot of fuckery going on, to be honest. I don't even know where to begin.
Anywhere, man. It's like a circle.
It's like one of those things that... It's like one of those things. What do you call it? It's, I don't even know where to begin, bro. It's these laws. There's a whole lot of fuckery going on, and I guess it's the Louisiana law that's really, really triggering me. And I don't know if everybody, I don't know if people don't know, like right now in the state of Louisiana, you have to really show your ID and just to view porn right now.
I'm sorry, say that again?
You have to show your ID. You have to submit your government issued ID to view porn.
What if I don't feel comfortable? What if I want to view porn in my own privacy?
Well, you got to show that IV. You got that ID?
Are you taking like a physical picture of your ID?
Something like that, yeah.
So you're saying... Huh. Go to my favorite porn site.
Yep. Pornhub, X videos.
Upload a picture of my
shit.
ID, my government ID. So it could scan and see that I'm actually of age to now pleasure myself.
Yep.
Are you worth it?
And he wonders why I'm laying here for therapy.
I don't know. Look, what is y'all's thoughts about that, man? I'm gonna be honest with you, dude. Like, that's some fucked up shit. That's like
the way he said it was hilarious.
You wonder why you. I mean, what? How does that make you feel?
It just doesn't sit right. Like, why are you so interested in having my ID to make sure I'm the right age in order to just, you know, pleasure myself?
I think it's the pleasure myself is why I'm giggling.
Well, right. The theory behind it is this therapist, right?
Okay.
This therapist, and she was getting a bunch of people, mm-hmm. Kids and young adults that was coming to her talking about, oh, the effects of porn that it's having on their relationships, on their psyche, on their, you know what I mean, on the, during the developmental stages of shit, you know what I mean? Mm. So she went on to like state legislature and created this bill to do it, and they did it. And that was their whole reasoning behind it. And that just ties into a whole bunch of things that's wrong with the United States right now, to me. I feel like we're taking the control out of the parents' hands, or the responsibility out of the parents' hands, and putting it into governments and the schools and teachers and shit like that. Like, I don't think that it's, I think it's the sole responsibility of the parent to decide what their kid views, you know what I mean? And how they view it. And if they're not doing a good enough job and their kids feels like they're slighted and it's the company's responsibility, and I don't think their parents did enough. They didn't do their job.
All right, let me give you a little bit of pushback.
What's up?
We're both guys, right?
Yeah.
You were telling your parents you were watching porn?
No.
Why not?
Because I didn't want to get fucking chewed out.
Okay.
I didn't want to get chewed out. We were coming up in the dial-up internet.
Uh-huh.
I didn't want to get viruses. You know what I mean? It was a whole bunch of shit why I didn't want to tell my parents why I was looking
you
at porn.
You used LimeWire before?
Okay. You used LimeWire all the time.
Oh, yeah, LimeWire.
Kazaa, LimeWire.
That.com.
Yeah. I didn't tell my parents anything.
Okay, so you didn't tell your parents anything about watching porn.
No.
You think these kids are doing the same thing and they're trying to sneak to watch porn in privacy without their parents knowing, in a sense, but you're saying for parents to monitor what their child watches.
Yeah.
I don't want my people knowing that I'm watching porn, so therefore you don't need to monitor what I'm doing to make myself feel good.
No.
In the privacy of my own room.
You can't do that. What right. you can do as a parent is make sure that they can't watch it. And now how do you do that? We work for the Snapple Factory. How do we do that? Parental controls, which are more accessible now than they were when we were kids. And they're easy to use. Like literally back in our day,
right.
you had to literally, cover your eyes type shit. You know what I mean? Don't go on that site. And it was very difficult to block certain sites. Like, it didn't get that until we were in high school and shit. You know what I mean? You just start blocking.
Are you 18 and plus?
Right. And that is your warning right sure. there.
Yeah.
That is your warning. So I don't think it should go any past that, past any further than that on regulating who sees what and how old you have to be. There's 2257 laws. There are FBI warnings on all these packages. There's on every ounce of legal content.
Correct.
Right? Mm. So why put it on the companies and on the state to regulate what's being consumed?
I mean, from what you said from the article, I'm not trying to get anything wrong from anything like that, but I mean, they're trying to protect their minds, because I could understand where she's coming from when it comes to porn messing up your minds, because some people could build an addiction, and that addiction could lead to other false fantasies that they think they could get away with in real life. So that could be a side or a point of view I see her coming from in order to protect like younger children from going through that. But then again, it's like you're still going through puberty around that time, and you're learning about your body and about yourself and sexual urges. Like, I'm not saying masturbation is a good thing or a bad thing, but it's just like I feel like if you're just trying to explore yourself to learn yourself as a human and body, it's natural, honestly.
Right, I get it. Yeah. But since it is so natural, right?
Right.
We can agree on that. Human sexuality is natural.
Right.
It's part of human life.
Yeah.
Why, and this brings me into the next topic, why doesn't the conversation start with the parents inside the home? Why aren't we having these conversations with our kids? Why are we leaving it up to the state, the teachers, everybody else who you want out, don't want in your business, all in your business when it comes to certain aspects of developmental stages of kids? Why? Why isn't it the responsibility, the sole responsibility of the parent?
Well, sometimes, depending on the household, I mean, I can't speak for a lot of people and stuff. Some people aren't in a household where parents are there. Some people aren't necessarily in a household where it's just like they have control over their kids.
Right.
Like I mean, for example, me, when I was a jit growing up, mm-hmm. like, what? I was, you right. do this, I'm going to do that. You right. say this, I'm going to do that. Right. So it's just like, yeah. So sometimes, you know, you have that rebellious child, and sometimes you do have parents who have control on their household and be strict on their child and tell them what to do. But sometimes those children, the way they react of being strict is just going to push them into doing, you know, bad, negative, unnecessary things just to get that experience.
I don't think it's a thing about being strict, right?
Right.
It's a thing about having and starting and having the conversation so your kid doesn't grow up being a fucking weirdo.
Right.
You know what I mean? I think a lot, like, did your parents, Tandy, did your fucking mom and your dad tell you about the birds and the bees? Did you have that? Raise your hand if you had that fucking conversation.
I'm also African, so everything's super conservative.
We're African American, Tanny. What the fuck?
No, I'm saying I'm African, and we don't talk about shit. It's so we're literally the antithesis of like communicate. We don't communicate about anything. Anything taboo, we don't even talk about.
Yeah, but see, that's the same thing about, I mean, you're saying African, but that's the same about Black culture in America. Like, you, not for nothing. You know, my girlfriend's dad, you know, when you talk about therapy, talking to somebody, it's like, fuck. Most often in the Black house, anyway, fuck all that. Nobody going to fucking therapy. You don't need no therapy. You just need to talk to me. You just need your parents. And in some rights, up until a certain stage, that's cool. Yeah, I can go to you for anything, dad, mom. But there are certain things that obviously you're not getting from your parents. And if they never taught you that, is it because they don't know? Or they refuse not to because it's a hard conversation.
I think it's just being born in different time periods in the sense that you can't get advice about a job or get advice about life in general from a parent.
But you can get advice on dating.
That you can.
Puberty.
That you can.
Friends.
You can. Get it. You can.
All these things, like growing up as a kid, your first 5 years, you're like a sponge. And then when do you stop teaching your kid?
No, I think it's more so the how is the part that you can't teach or get advice from your parents.
Right.
Because it changes from decade to decade. Watch this. So how you do whatever it is that they want you to do changes.
Watch this. But,
hit me.
All right. So my parents are immigrants, right? I ain't learned none of that shit from them. I ain't talk about sex. They didn't teach me about puberty. They ain't teach me about none of that shit. I just knew that shit all from firsthand experience. Mm-hmm. Oh shit, why the fuck am I whipping my dick out? Why am I masturbating?
I felt uncomfortable. What is happening right now?
Why does this feel good? I can't tell my parents this because the way they're raised, being Christian and, you know, religion and stuff like that, there's a sin. So it's just like, fuck, I got to keep this to myself type shit. Out here, you know, puberty and all this other stuff is just like, all right, you're going through that. My parents really didn't teach me that. I had the school teach me that. I learned about the birds and the bees in third grade because it was required in school.
Third grade.
Sixth grade is
when I got mine.
Third grade, we already learned about this.
I was literally a sophomore in college when I learned about the birds. That's crazy.
It's just like what you said, the times you were raised.
That's true.
Because third grade, we already knew about the sexual reproduction system.
Huh?
I still thought girls had cooties in third grade.
Bro, third grade, I didn't. Somebody could have told me what a vagina, should have showed me a vagina, and I would have guessed it was something else.
And that's a good segue to this. Some people, they go through different experiences in life where they learn sex at a young age.
Right.
Like, for example, I know this homeboy of mine, ever since we were young, his older brother and influences, they stay bringing chicks to the crib. So we learned that at a super young age. Mm-hmm. Oh, snap, this is the thing that you got to do. You feel me?
Right.
And therefore, you have people that are going through phases in life at a young age thinking that this is what they got to do. So they develop that mindset of like, oh, okay, I got to get this. I got to get that. For example, let me put it to you. If you don't mind sharing this information. How old were you when you lost your virginity?
We just literally 19. Talked about 19? This.
You said 19?
Yeah.
How old were you when you lost your virginity?
I was 15.
How old do you think I was when I lost my virginity?
10.
21.
11.
11?
Damn, I was close.
11.
He had 10 energy. I don't know.
You was like third grade sex education.
He was out here multiplying while he was multiplying.
Because you got to understand the time, the place you were, if you had parents around you or not, your influences and stuff like that, at a young age, your brain's still developing.
So absolutely.
Therefore, you're still in that
See, and
developing stage.
How do y'all feel about the ages where you lost your virginity? Like, looking back, how do you guys feel about
it? I think that it was appropriate. I think high school, honestly, I'd like, realistically, the age most people would lose their virginity is probably high school, freshman year of college.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, that's when I would think so, you know? But we got the cases like 11, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Wouldn't you have wished it would have been different if you had your parents to say something to you? Because I wish I would have had mine. I wish I would have had my dad to just be like, look, this is how you do this. This is how you do that. And had I known that, I probably wouldn't have had sex with the first person I had sex with. I'm disgusted by that shit.
Okay. Due to me losing it at a young age, like I brought up the example, your influences is what like helps mold you at such a young age. So at that time, we were already exposed to porn and stuff like that. So when it was happening to me, in my mind, I'm like, oh shit, we're doing a porno. Because she was older, she knew what she was doing, and she was teaching me what to do in order for her to get what she needed.
Let me ask you, let's take it a step further. Do you think porn influences the way you see sex?
Yes.
Yes, at a young age, because I'm going to put it to you like this. It's funny. When you're watching porn, you feel me? For some people, like my friend, when we first introduced him to porn and shit like that, and then when it came to sexual reproduction system and all that other shit, he's thinking like women take it up the ass and give birth out the ass.
Right, because they're seeing doggy style
and not wondering what the hell, and that fucks their mind up. And that's why they want to put the IDs for this porn shit, because at a young age, you're letting something that's for adults warp in your mind. How you think we get some of these people that think this is okay to do, depending on the categories.
It's almost like it's the standard.
Yeah. Porn is the standard.
That's wild.
Sex sells.
Sex sells.
Bro. In any entertainment industry, sex sells.
Bro. Straight up.
No, you're right.
But how do you counteract that? How do you counteract that interpretation of what you're seeing in porn to something that's more positive, that like I can learn from this because I already have a general sense of what sex is. Now this shit seems like advanced. I can learn from this now in my other. That kind of conversation starts with yo in the house.
Right. So yeah, I was gonna say, are you coming from like you being the dad telling your
Absolutely. I wish my dad would have been like, look, son, this is what it is. This
how
is what you're gonna go.
Are you gonna be though, Brandon?
Like, well, right. That's what like, I'm trying to figure out. How transparent.
As in like, because I don't know the answer to that.
You gotta be super transparent with your 16-year-old son. You know what I mean? Or you're 15-year-old, you're 14, saying, you're
y'all
you're
lost
freshman.
Your virginity at like 10, 11?
No, I said 15.
Like, okay, I got you. But shouldn't you do it earlier then? Because you lost your virginity earlier.
He or she might have friends that be like, hey, look at this. You don't know what your child is doing.
True, true.
You don't know the influence around your child.
So this is a better question.
So how early do you let them know? That's why we learned super early.
Right.
So by the time we got old, we're like, oh, all right. Me, I feel like this. Funny inside story. I got my first set of pubes at 9. So once I got that,
you're bragging right now.
Yeah, bro.
I got my last week, and you out here just bragging. That's cool.
I was waiting for mine since I was like 13. I was like, oh shit, they're finally starting to come.
Never, not at all.
9 years old.
But I feel like around the ages, if they could comprehend around the ages of 9 or 10, would be like, you don't have to go balls to the wall. You could just like, hey, you might be feeling some things. You're about to go through some things. If you feel comfortable as your parent, as your friend, you can always let me know so I could help you understand what you're going through and I could guide you. And if you're feeling these things and emotions and like deep hormonal feelings where you feel like, I'll be like,
damn, as you're saying it, I'm like, actually I'm thinking.
Bro, hit a button.
We should, I would say, I'd say maybe even earlier now. Now that you're saying it, it'll make sense to prep kids before it even happens.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Well, okay, so
I don't know.
They do have books to teach your small kids this shit.
A book
they
can
read. No, but it's not it's story time. It's anatomy books that you read your kids when they're going to get. Well, this is because I mean, if a 3 year old and 3 or 4 year old that's still at home under the care of their mother is gonna see their mom's ass and tits, right?
Depending on the parent, a parent might be strict and be like, "I don't want my child to see this."
Is that the right approach?
We don't.
I think that's
the
debate.
It's not.
I don't know how to.
However, you raise your child is how you want to raise your child. You could be a nudist and your child only sees y'all naked at home, and your child goes to a friend's house and be like, "Why does your parents have clothes on?"
I think to that point, the person who's raised by whose parents are nudists, they would see porn or a naked lady and wouldn't be so hypersexual.
Mm.
You know what I mean? They wouldn't be so because that's the thing. It's hypersexuality that we're skating around. That's the term. Why when we look at porn, we think we can do that in real life just off the rip because that's just what we see. So does porn create hypersexuality? Yeah, but how do you counteract that? The conversations that you have in the house, true or false?
True.
Seems right.
Yeah.
I don't have real hand experience.
I don't either.
But it's just like.
But I also don't think that because we're these conversations aren't being well. We know this. I also feel that there shouldn't be any regulation other than what we have. Warnings, 18 and over warnings. There shouldn't be. You shouldn't have to be putting your government ID in there in a database to see, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think that's right.
Yeah, no, that part is just.
If I lose my ID, I can't jack off? Fuck out of here.
You gotta clock in and watch porn.
Every time. No, I gotta create that.
I feel like they're just monitoring
your
porn limit.
You take away anonymity. You take.
They're gonna hit you with the, all right, so we could sell him on ads. We could start messing up his algorithm. We could get him more addicted.
Bro.
Mess up his dopamine. Mess up his serotonin. Goddamn, okay, now we done made this man a porn addict. Now they finna put you in some type of thing to brainwash you and hit you with some therapy and shit so they can make money off your ass and type of shit.
That's what I'm thinking,
because who's gonna be
oh,
in charge
Brandon,
of looking?
You've masturbated for 3
back again,
hours
I see
on a
fit time this day.
Outstanding.
Imagine going to court for that shit. You know what I mean?
High score.
Sir. It says here you've masturbated a total of 10 times today.
Matter of fact, it says you're doing it right now. What is going on?
12 p.m.
Fucking Zoom. You get a Zoom call for the courtrooms now. Hell no.
No.
I'm good.
No. That's wild, though.
That's just weird. It's just like, why?
Tanny, how do you feel about it? Do you think they should put, you should be able to, you have to put your fucking ID in? Show your ID to get to see some porn?
Let's keep it a buck. Kids always know how to get around whatever restriction it is, right? Whether it's parental guidance with this and this. Like, you did it as a kid. You know kids before they've done it. Your kids are going to do the same thing as much as you feel like they're going to be smarter than you. Or less smarter than you. But at the end of the day, there's always a way to get around it. I think it's just stupid. It's just unnecessary red tape to put people on blast for just no reason.
Right. And who's in charge of viewing these IDs and saying, all right, this is cool? And how long does it take? Is there like, who? There has to be somebody sitting there like, all right, bet. Cool. He's good. Mm-hmm. He's good. He's good. He's good.
It's like getting into
like the fucking weed dispensary.
That's so dangerous getting that information too. Like every single time you go on a site like that, like a black site.
Where is your information being sent to?
Maybe a guy.
Hell no. I'm good. I'm Gucci. I won't be traveling. I won't be viewing any porn in Louisiana anytime soon. I'd say that.
Or
I will. I will have it pre-recorded though.
Okay, gotcha.
Yes. Pre-record. Yeah.
Yes.
Load it to your phone.
Some AI shit. No, G shit. Because think about it like this now. Think about it like this. We're like what? Mid-20s, 30s.
Oh, we definitely 30.
See how he shows his age.
I got facial hair.
Yeah, I got facial hair too. All right.
I hope so.
Let's think about it like, well, I mean, I hit puberty at 9 years old. So.
That's what I was alluding to.
So let's think about it like this. By the time we got kids or they got kids, right? And this metaverse shit, just imagine porn there. And then they already got all your information. Now they could go ahead and make your own little AI skin. Oh, let me fantasize about a coworker. Let me log in, download your skin because some AI got your shit from previous when you're watching porn, And then bada bing, bada boom. Now
I don't want no motherfucker. Oh, telling me when I can and can't. I'm a grown ass man. You gonna tell me who gonna say I can't? And I gotta put in. I gotta show ID just to look at some shit that's on my computer.
My boy gotta clock in.
Fuck out of here. You can kiss my ass, Louis.
Sir, you must hit 80 hours before you can do this.
Sir, you use your hours for the day.
Yeah. No, we're gonna cut you off.
Nah, man.
These are the only clips you're allowed to watch.
Your foreskin will thank you.
Oh my.
All right. Y'all, you ready for a smoke break?
I'm about it.
All right, let's take a smoke break real quick.
All right, for sure.
All right.
Hello?
Yep,
you're in there. Ooh,
all right, cool.
Yeah. Action. Oh, shit, we're cooking.
Wait, could you hear yourself?
I don't know.
I can hear you.
I don't think so.
Hold on one
second. We can hear you.
Because I don't know what I'm hearing for, if that makes sense.
Can you hear yourself now?
Could you hear
Hello?
Us?
Hello? Yo, yeah. I can hear everybody.
All right, cool. All right, Brandon, bring us in.
This is what happens when you bring niggas to the podcast. And Tanny, I think we're going back to the original view, the original setup where it's a table and chairs. You introduce a couch, niggas want to lay out. You know what I'm saying? You ever gone to the bathroom and then you come out and then the nigga, your homeboy is just laid out on your couch, niggas just feet up, moved off all the fucking.
That is actually low key me.
Bro, so, it's just 100%. Like, bro, it's like
that. Literally in Timberlands and everything.
You know, that's we was me. Just about to leave, right?
Oh, like now?
We going back to tables and chairs.
Your boys, like, make yourself at home.
That is fair.
What do you think that person's gonna do?
100%. You gotta be super confident when you say that. Lean into it, like, yo.
You sure you want me to make myself at home, at your home? Sure about that?
They can start for sure. They can start like this to the pillows and shit.
Nah, see, that's just
say. Well, what time's like, dinner, bro? What time's dinner?
Shit, make yourself at home. Yo, you got a blanket. It's cold, bro.
Low key, yeah.
I wish.
Nah, man. So coming off a smoke break, dog.
Yeah. How you feeling now, man?
Look.
Yo. Are you hot?
Damn, that smoke was hitting different.
I know it, bro.
That was a 10-second pause.
A man had a glitch in the system.
He said
he had to reboot.
No, are you gonna introduce your guest? We got some new people in the house.
Oh yes,
we got some
beautiful ray of sunshine right here. The glowing essence, you feel me? Just radiating on this couch right next to me. This is Madam Hava.
If you haven't guessed by now, this is his girlfriend. This is his woman.
I have a button for this.
If you haven't guessed.
There you go. Right. Sorry, that's the quickest one I could find.
We didn't.
Cover's blown.
Cover's blown.
Fuck it.
Well, welcome to the show.
Yeah, find out.
Shit, we here now. Shit. Fuck's going on?
A little technical difficulties.
Yes, it should be like a little ox
under the right one. There you go.
Timestamp killer. Edit that out.
Mm-mm.
All right, so what are we talking about, Brandon?
Andrew,
everything's raw.
No. Everything's raw. Everything's raw, bro. This is what you're talking about.
What are you sipping, bro?
I'm sipping coffee.
Do you have any sugar in there?
No.
That's coffee?
No fucking sugar.
That's diabolical.
This is coffee, bro.
My nigga, that is mud water.
Nah, bro. See, what happened was I put too much, but it tastes good.
I told you.
Look, well,
okay, I told you this okay, would okay. happen.
Why do you drink coffee?
I love coffee.
Because I don't drink alcohol. I quit drinking and I need something to keep me up. This is my pick me up.
Well, congratulations on
that. Yeah, man. I'm like 2 months.
Yeah. I stopped drinking too.
No, you didn't. Fuck out of here.
He's not drinking. He's sipping, bro.
Not.
It's a different.
This is grape juice.
Do not.
Fermented.
Fermented.
Yes. But it's grape juice. Yes. Thank you.
Shout out to Welch.
Fermented. And distilled.
Welch. That's from the Welch Island.
Yes, absolutely.
This is very hot. Coffee.
Mud water.
Tanny put me on black coffee. Thank
Honestly,
you.
Honestly, black coffee is the best way to drink it. Like,
says who?
Just no, 100% is. There's so many health benefits to it. Black coffee?
Like Nescafe is actually really good, okay?
What the fuck's
Nescafe? I didn't go that deep,
like,
but.
French vanilla and all that shit. Nescafe is like the, you put it in it. Y'all don't know shit.
All right, so y'all had a heated debate earlier, right?
Correct.
Right, earlier, I mean 10 minutes ago. What were y'all talking about?
No,
I want to hear about this.
Was it really a debate or was I was just schooling y'all?
Was it heated?
It was a little bit like schooling. How do you, gosh, I don't want to say like train kids, but how do you
train
How do you raise kids? What's the best way to raise kids?
How do you prepare to raise your clone?
How do you train kids not to be hypersexual? Hypersexual?
I never said that.
No, but that, I mean, essentially, that's what it is. Not to be fucking weird.
What if they're just naturally hypersexual?
Bro, I thought you know we're talking like, about
that's true.
Porn and IDs.
Okay.
But porn and IDs, but the ideology behind that, why this because of hypersexuality or skewed points of views of porn, what it does to kids. Remember we just said, there's a lot of kids out there that's sitting here saying porn fucked up their life.
Okay.
Right. You know what I mean? Kids are actually saying that?
Yeah. That's what I said. But apparently this is true. In the comment section, just go ahead and comment if you feel like that's true or false. Like you think kids are out here mad that porn comes? I think it's one of those niche communities on Twitter. It's one of those Twitter communities. You know what I mean? That's like, hey, you porn companies are putting too much porn out and you guys aren't regulating it. And we are overproducing porn.
It's what I said before, man.
Fuck no.
They're overproducing it to a point it's going to start addictions. It's going to be like, you would rather masturbate than build a actual healthy relationship with an actual woman due to the fact that you could
pleasure yourself
at any moment
and not get cussed out after
phone and like
it's actually really
no, I mean, I think a lot of women would feel that way. I don't think any woman out there would want their man watching porn.
But
woman,
it could go both ways as well.
I'm a woman, I can.
Because women watch porn too, so I feel like it could go both ways, but I'm not sure. I'm not a woman, though.
I feel like women's porn is like 50 Shades of Grey.
Nah.
I don't know. Because some
kind of like my the girl, emotional my girl likes gay sensuality.
Porn. Some to girls it. Put me on to some fire shit.
So there actually is like a porn site, like, catering to women. It's called Balesa.
So Balesa? How is it Balesa? Different?
How do you spell that?
B-E-L-L-E-S-A, I think. Yeah.
Okay.
Balesa. So how is it different as far as like the content?
It's more so, I feel like in general, because I can't speak for all women, and I definitely am like a small portion of like not regular women. Like I don't fall into the category of like general. But I would say that there's a lot more foreplay in the videos.
Mm.
There's a lot more like attention to like the woman rather than it just being like getting shots and angles, which I feel like regular porn is. It's just a bunch of like, getting the angles or you're really like, they're also dramatizing a lot of things too. Like when girls squirt, they're like shooting it out there. It's not normal for everyone to do that. And
there's
three types of orgasms when it comes to women.
True.
So
true.
You could have one that's like more, it's actually more natural for women to have it's another term for it. It's not orgasm like outward the way men do, where like you're shooting at the club, but it's like inward.
Right, of course.
So like sometimes when a woman meets her climax, like that's a kind of like first orgasm.
But is it, but also a lot of women I feel haven't even tapped into that side of their sexuality. There's a huge chunk of women out there that's never even had an orgasm.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that like they don't even know what that means. You know what I mean? They're like, what? You know? Like, and that's true. That's happened to me a few times in my adulthood, where the girl's like, I don't know what it feels like. I get to a point and I was just like, there's a lot of pressure and I don't know. And then
I was first told it feels like you're about to pee or something like that.
Yeah, the pressure, like, yeah. And then they don't.
If you feel that, don't, basically don't tense up or try and like push it away. Just kind of let it, like relax and just let it happen. I think breathing is a big thing to incorporate.
Now, question, would you feel comfortable talking about this with your children?
Nope.
Why not?
Nope.
I feel like I feel like a mother should have that conversation with her daughter. Mm. Absolutely.
Mm. Oh, God.
Absolutely.
That's so awkward.
Because what is she?
And this I feel
is
like the it's point. Very Look, easy to say because though, like on do? Paper, but like
I would not want if the my daughter's kids... watching porn and she sees someone squirt, she's gonna think that's her main.
No,
goal.
What I'm saying, I don't disagree with you guys. Right? It's just more so that conversation is not as easy as you making it seem.
We're not saying it's easy.
My bad.
It's just like
I'm saying it's necessary, and I'm also saying that it's not happening.
How do you do that though?
Hey, Susie. I'm gonna teach you something right now. Nah. Honestly, I wouldn't want my son learning anything from his dumbass homies who don't know shit.
So then I feel like the best way to approach you, like, being able to have that dynamic with your kids is you have to kind of set the tone as far as, like, your child knows that they can come to you for right. any type of questions.
Right.
Mm. So, like, they're not scared of coming to you because you might be, like, you might react a certain way. So that means that whatever, before y'all even start talking about sex, anything else that they might get in trouble for.
Right.
There already needs to be a set tone of, like, okay, if I get in trouble, this might happen to me. But when it comes to certain topics, like questions or anything, because yeah. I grew up in a very, like, sheltered community, uh-huh. missionary community. It's kind of like being a pastor's kid in combination with being, like, a military brat.
Right.
You can't say certain things. Right. Like, so I feel like, and then you, at least for me, like, I knew how my parents felt about certain things, so I was automatically not going to approach them about certain things.
Right.
I actually think I even told one of my friends one time that I was scared of my mom. Because, like, I seen all my friends, like, they could have conversations with their mom about, like, boys and all that stuff. I wasn't able to do that.
And for me,
if I knew that my mom was a lot more approachable at a younger age right. and I could tell her, like, I could get shit off my chest, like, okay. get my thoughts
what
off my chest.
What made you scared?
That's good.
Was it the upbringing?
That's a good question, because one of the things was I seen her temper. I seen how she would lash out at things that she did not like. Right. Like, she didn't fuck with it. She was like, why? But even simple things, like, I got dress coded in my own home. So, like, well, I remember one time I got in trouble because I rolled my shorts. Like, my shorts were probably, like, right above the knee.
Right.
I rolled it up twice. And I got, like, laid out for that shit.
So it was the fear and temper that struck that. So it didn't make you feel comfortable of opening it up to
also, have, I think, my mom made it known. She was like, oh, I'm not your friend. You can be my friend, but I'm not your friend. Okay. So yeah, she said the tone of, like,
a lot of parents. Like, I'm not your friend.
Of course,
what are you talking about?
But even when she said, like, oh, you could be my friend, you could tell me stuff, I didn't necessarily feel comfortable to, oh, I'm gonna say this too. I'm this type of person. My sister, she probably have a completely different, like, response, but if I know that you're open and you're open-minded to at least hear my thought, even if it's wrong or whatever, and you don't condemn me for it, I'm a lot more, like, just willing to be more open, truthful, stuff like that. But I think I started being more vocal or sharing my personal stuff, like, as a young adult, when I realized, like, my mom started sharing more stuff about herself.
Mm. Mm.
So, like I said, like, My parents raised me very sheltered. So at the point where sometimes they would tell me about stuff, it was a little too fucking late. Like, things had already happened. So, but through those, like, discussions, I was able to find out how my parents actually felt about stuff, what actually happened in their life, like, when they were my age.
Yeah.
So then it kind of put things into perspective later on, like, oh, that's why you act like that. Oh, that's why da 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 da. So, like, I feel like I had one of the craziest talks my parents ever had with me one time was after they found out that I was cutting, and they freaked out because they were like, oh, we're going to get sent back on the mission field for this. And I just thought that was crazy. Like, you care more about what the mission fields,
like, as opposed to actually what's going on with you.
How your child is actually feeling, or, like, what they're going through right now, mentally, emotionally, all that stuff. So, like, one of the things she told me, though, during that discussion was, it was a 2-hour-long discussion, or I would say more like a monologue, but she was basically like...
He said monologue.
Yeah, she was basically like...
One way, just the entire way.
One thing about parents is if they ever show any type of, like, anger or anything, because one of the things that she was like, why didn't you tell me? I'm like, I don't feel like I could talk to you. Like, right. I don't feel like you're approachable.
And she yeah.
was like, well, one thing about parents, punished. Like, if you ever feel scared to tell them something... The reason why they're showing that type of aggression or anger is probably because of fear. More likely than not, it's because of fear. Once I understood that, oh, y'all just tripping too. Y'all don't know what the fuck y'all doing. I was like,
and see, I understand that, but see, you don't understand that your parents are figuring it out as they go.
So
until
I feel
you're an
like
adult,
the best thing that parents can do as parents is be transparent with their kids
right.
from jump. Like, the same way that you express your emotions with your children, mm-hmm. not like, okay, they don't have to know about your money problems.
Are we saying be 100% transparent, though?
No.
Also, like
you
said before, there's a balance there, right?
I feel like with every single person that you have in your life, yeah, you have to have that balance.
I'm not going to give them, you know, the birds and the bees at three. Like, you know what I mean?
Third grade intercourse.
Where do you find the balance?
I feel like it's like this. different, different age group of range. You okay. Expose them more.
That's
more
than literally right. What I was saying.
If you're 8 to 10,
you should have a curriculum.
7 to 10, be like,
you should have like your own sexuality curriculum.
But how do you know when to introduce into them? Like we were saying before,
right?
Like kids learn faster than we think they do.
Of
right?
course,
right? So how do you know when to introduce them to all this shit?
You gotta pay attention to your kid. You have to be
Brandon,
like,
for example, very did your parents know everything you were doing in middle school?
No.
Were they on top of it?
Fuck no.
Be honest.
Look. My mom knew some shit that I didn't think anybody fucking knew.
Were you ahead of her on any point, though?
It only took one time for my mom to be like, oh, and I knew you was over at such and such.
Then again, you're not the most covert, though. I feel like you're
like... I wasn't trying to be, but I'm not saying I wasn't out in the open, but I wasn't trying to be not out in the open growing up. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't give a fuck.
I didn't tell my mom.
But my mom, she knew some shit. So, and then my dad is the one who is kind of like, huh, okay, whatever. You left the house. Bye. I'll see you when you come home. That's how my dad is. My dad never called like.
But your mom was literally on top.
On top of it, but not overbearing. You know what I mean? It wasn't like she was like, hey, call. She was definitely like, call me when you get here. Call me if you're going to be late type shit. You know, I never did. You know what I mean? But she knew. She knew. People told her shit. Fucking snitches.
Being a parent is so hard.
I think moms naturally sense things though too. Yeah. Because I never told my mom when I lost my virginity, but months later when I finally like opened up about like, oh, okay, this and this and this happened like 6 months ago. This is what was going on during this time. She was like, I know, and I was like, oh, okay.
Right. No, I mean.
So that's what I'm saying. Like my mom would say, oh, I know my child pretty well. She might not know like everything that I'm doing right now or how I am like evolving into, but she stays present enough. She checks in with me like once a week. Like if she doesn't hear from me, she reaches out.
So yeah,
I feel like it's the same concept like when you're like raising your kids.
Okay, so let's bring it all back. So the transparency with the kids, and I think we're all in unison that basically is the route to go to raising your fucking kids is being transparent with them and being open about sexuality. Now, what?
Yeah, no, of course. Because to reel it back real quick on what you had said, when do you know it's time to talk about that with your children?
And your maturity. Your kids, I mean, you're like you said, like, well,
no,
you know.
No, I was just saying the idea just struck upon me because I was just like, oh, whenever you feel like you're ready as a parent, but then again, it's like you better be first before someone else.
That's the sweet spot.
But how do you determine when does that first interaction? I remember like everybody has that friend. It's like, hey, I got this. My uncle left these pornos and some shit like that. You know what I mean?
For sure.
That can happen in fucking second grade, third grade. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you're also not looking at it the same way.
But that's what I'm saying. If you're close enough with your child is going to already automatically go home and be like, mommy, so today I da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah, show
like,
me this.
Because
yeah,
there's just like that. They'll go home and they'll say exactly what happened the entire day.
Right. But there's some just that...
That don't say shit. But that's literally how... Like, within a household, you could be strict. You could do everything right. And one kid, I was the rebel, were getting to do their own thing. My sister does everything like... How my parents ask her to. She still asked my parents for advice and this, that, and the third. Me, I'm not. You give me your advice. I will take into consideration, but it's not going to be. I can't guarantee I'm going to take your. You know what I mean?
Right.
Everybody's going to be different, but I just feel like that's the blueprint, if you will. Yeah. Like this, to simplify it, like transparency and then having the balance of knowing like when to say something, when not. But like that's where. I feel like people are not tapped in with their intuition. So if you have intuition, good. A lot of this would be a lot easier done than just saying it. Like, you know what I mean?
It's like, this kid's been upstairs for 30
minutes.
That's
what I'm saying.
I don't even think that it's intuition. I think you know. Like, all right.
That's intuition. You
know,
that's what I'm saying.
But it's not about that, though. What I think it is, how do I approach this little nigga? I know he's in the bathroom jacking off. What do I say?
wisdom nothing. And intuition.
How do
I open up? I know you're jacking off in there,
but
boy.
And then what happens? He'll never come to you.
But you
he
know,
will never fuck with you.
I think it's parenting styles, personality styles, because yeah. every child is different. So, right. like, different. For example, I'll use what do you call it? I'll use astrology to help me understand people. I'm not doing it to down to a science where it's like, oh, every person is like this or everybody that has this sign is like this type shit, right?
Right.
Because everybody is a combination of those things. If you study your child enough, like, you know how, like, what's going to approach. Because if my sister got put on blast how I was put on blast for certain things, she would not react the same way. And she has not reacted right. the same way.
Right.
Vice versa. If you try to put the pressure on me how y'all put on my sister, it's not going to work.
Yeah.
I'm going to shut down. So same thing. Like, if you feel like that child is more of like a private person and they might get embarrassed or this, that, and the third, you would approach it as that, right. as such. Like,
so basically, you guys, people out there listening, find the balance. If you have kids and you're raising some fucking little ass, badass kids, find the fucking balance.
Get to know your child.
Get to know your child. Find the friend parent balance. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You enough to be like, my kid is going to come to me whenever he has a problem, no matter what. But parent enough to know that, you know, I'm still going to, but that parent, I'm going to be stern when you do fuck up.
Right.
You know
I feel I mean? Like
I'm not going to, just because we are tight and we're on this quote unquote friendship doesn't mean I won't fuck you up.
Exactly.
I think also, like, going back to like setting the tone, a lot of parents think like, oh, like ideally they might even have this in their head, like, oh, I'm doing it right, like I'm gonna say this and that, and I have like a whole idea in their head, but then they've already been acting out like their own emotions in a not maybe like the bet, like maybe toxic way. So right. their kids already absorbed and perceived how they respond to other situations. So now, with that being said, whether you tell them or not that, oh, you can tell me anything, da 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 da. Well, right. I beg to differ because I've seen you react to da 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 when it comes
this
to
reminds
this.
Me of that show, fucking Georgia and Jeannie on fucking Netflix. You guys watch that shit?
Bro, no, you're saying the most random shows.
No, that's not that random. People are like, oh my God, I watched that shit.
Has anyone here seen Georgia and Jeannie?
Write in the comments. Let us know.
Yeah, bro, people are going to write in the comment section. What, they keep trying to play me like, I'm not up on popular culture. You know what I'm saying?
Georgia and Jeannie.
No, the dynamic in that is as a mother and daughter, it's a young mother who is our age and has a daughter who is like 16 and going
through
like
and they're going to the clubs together and all that.
No, they're not going to the clubs together.
I've seen that happen.
No, like, right. I've seen that happen too. But they're not going to the clubs together, but they're going through similar situations, through relationships with each other, and they're battling the same shit and they're learning with
what's
each
it called
other.
Again?
Georgia and Jeannie.
I'm going to put it down.
Jeannie
right now.
With a G.
I got you.
It's a great show, and it shows you the dynamic exactly what we're talking about, because they grew up. Georgia is the mom, raised Jeannie like a friend. Like we're homies and shit like that. So now you have this teenager.
Jeannie and Georgia, you're right.
Who's getting away with mad shit.
Who's getting, she's not a bad kid. She's actually really smart.
Right.
But, you know, what age did we lose Virginia? She's having sex. Mm. She's going through, and her mom she wants to be that stern mom, but she has these flashbacks like, fuck, I had a kid at 16. How can I tell my kid not to be doing this when I was doing this? You know what I mean? So
it's like every
balance is kind of like, fucked up.
I don't want
up,
you going
but it's
through
a,
what I
you know,
went
but,
through
but
my
it works.
Type stuff.
But I feel like, okay, when you're giving advice and you've already done something in your past that kind of contradicts
makes you a contrarian.
That, yeah. I feel like the best way to give advice is to say, well, I did this. You can learn from my example, but also just kind of give them the different options so they can choose for themselves.
Mm-hmm,
like you could go this way and this and say
what if
it
your
more,
kid is dumb?
Then you're good.
Not in like, you know.
No,
like think about it. Like not saying
good.
That obviously.
No, that's
what
I'm saying. Like,
if your kid is not able to process
like,
things.
Like, bro, you ain't never going to get it, bro.
I ain't got it.
No, not
you
in the
never get
it. Gosh, it sounded bad when I said it. But yes, it was for shock value. But at the same time, yo, what if you know your kid doesn't process that quick? Will you still give him those options?
Yeah.
I feel like if you treat a child,
take your time
like
with the child.
Intelligent, no, because I've seen my uncle do this with his kids. He talked to his kids like they were like his peers. Like he talked, and they had a good vocabulary at a young age. Like they were still toddlers because they knew how to talk
right.
to an adult. Like they didn't talk to him like a kid. They didn't act like a kid. They talked to him like an individual. But I was gonna say like.
It sounds like we're literally, and none of us have kids, by the way. We are literally out here giving motherfuckers
not that we know
a print of how to raise a kid. You know what I mean?
We're kids that have grown up, experienced being a child, and then we have our own opinion. We formed our own opinions based off of our experiences.
Right.
So moving forward, like, you know how like kids be like, oh, I'm not going to be like my parents because da 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 da. That's kind of how we're going to be like. And if we did like how our parents parented, then we're going to use an element of how they parented us
right.
with an element of how we think that our kids should be parented.
Yeah.
With hopefully an element of how does my kid want to be parented?
I was trying to pull up the stat, but that right there. Most people actually parent people based on their parents. I'm trying to pull up the stat right now. As far as like the way we parent, we actually get it from our parents.
Yeah.
So like she was saying, yo, I don't want to be like a parent, but at the end of the day, we actually parent the same way. Our parents do, which is actually bad.
Yeah, that's that learned behavior. That's that learned behavior.
But like, that's what I'm saying.
What creates a fuckboy? What creates a bad dater? You know what I mean? What creates a bad woman? What creates a bad man? What creates these people who we despise in relationships? Is it bad parenting?
I can't.
Like, who fucking raised you?
I can't.
You ever dated somebody? Like, who fucking raised you?
Yeah.
Who like, where you? The fuck did you get this shit from? Like, bro, let me call your mom. Like, you a fucking idiot, dog. You never dated somebody like that?
No.
I have.
I could say this.
No.
I could say this.
Like, who the fuck raised you?
You could be a parent, alcoholic, druggy, whatever. You could have, like, multiple siblings.
Mm-hmm.
They could look at you as an example and be like, I don't ever want to be like that. Or you could have one of those siblings to be like, shit. Parents did it. This is how I process it. I think this is right. So I'm going to go ahead and be that junkie of the family out of my siblings because I get that from what I thought. And you got kids who's like,
That's a way of fucking thinking.
I don't want to be that. Man. I don't want to live through that. When I have children, I don't want them to go through that because they go through traumatic experiences where it's just like, I know what that outcome could be if I'm just like that parent. I would not want that for my child. So therefore, I'm going to go this route.
Hopefully,
to my child, they could pass it on and whatnot.
You just can't
but
do
it's
it
like,
out of
yeah.
fear. Right. As soon as you try to make it out of fear, that becomes like
that becomes
fear
the fear of what
becomes
people
right. the reality.
But now the crazy thing about
but you could
that
control that
is sadly the psyche of the person who you're gonna follow what your parent does. No, it's very very is more often you're gonna follow. You're going to follow exactly what your parents do than to see, I'm not going to do that if it's a bad situation.
Because it's conditioning.
Exactly. And it's sad because you would like to, I think that way. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to do that to my kid.
Well, Brandon, what do you say to, remember that article we talked about? The 2001 article with the serial killer? I don't know if you remember that. It was more so.
Jog my memory.
So what it was is you had two twins that lost both their parents,
right,
ended up in foster homes, and one became super successful, one became a serial killer and in jail about to go on death row. And the craziest thing about that, and they tracked them, they both had the same answer for how they ended up in the same situation.
They're done.
Wild.
Right.
So they hit up the successful person and they were like, yo, with parents the way you had them, how did you become successful? He was like, yo, growing up how I did, there was no way I couldn't do it. I just saw what it was and what I wanted. It's just, there was no way I couldn't do it. And it was crazy because the serial killer had the same thing.
Right.
Yo, with parents the way I had them, how could I not end up this way?
The interpretation.
Exactly. So
it's the
all
interpretation.
About perception.
The mentality.
Perception.
Yeah.
And personality.
But, and sadly, perception is reality, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what you are seeing and how you perceive it is often what you're going to emulate. So that's why is more often more times you're going, if your dad is a loud cursing person, that's exactly who the fuck you're going to be in this fucking
true
relationship.
I feel like it's more,
you know what I mean?
I feel like it's more mannerisms
and you can't escape that, and it's hard to escape that. You really have to have that, like, I'm not going to be that person.
Triggers and traumas.
I find myself turning into my dad a lot in like you were just
I
saying.
I feel like it's more
mannerisms and shit. You know what I mean?
I'll put it to you like this. The way I was brought up and grew up, I would never put my kid through that. And especially the physical torture.
Mm-hmm.
I can't do that to a freaking child I brought into this world, bro. My heart would fucking break doing that shit.
Yeah.
Love that you said that because it goes both ways, like, right? Like, mm-hmm. you either emulate what your parents did or you go so far off the deep end. So like, far on the other side. End, to right. be able like,
I don't
not to be
ever want to bring a child into the world and put you through what the fuck I done been through because I'm saying, oh, I got this from my parents. No, because I'm my own person. I'm my own mind. What I see, I know right from wrong. I'm not finna do wrong
right.
when I know what's right. Because inside me, that ain't right.
But
so just like mannerisms.
What you said, conditioning.
Or stuff like that.
You know what I mean? Sometimes that conditioning, that trumps everything you're talking about. Because you try to escape it, but you go. It's like I grew up in a household where my parents, they fought. Okay. You know what I mean? And I told myself, that's not what I'm going to do in my relationship. Mm-hmm. I'm not. And fuck that. Because you know I can't. And the next thing I know, fucking.
What led you to that?
You know what? Learned behavior. It was comfortable being there at that level. You know what I'm saying? Because I was so used to it.
Product of your environment.
Product of your environment. But you try to condition yourself to be the opposite. So sometimes the circumstances and the situation says fuck what your psyche is telling you to do the opposite. You know what I mean?
So I feel like the reason why that happens though is because people just haven't had the time or like just they haven't been able to work on themselves to the point that they've been able to stop that cycle from happening.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So it's just it's a matter of you getting to a certain point of healing mm-hmm. to where you're able to now like
or you acknowledging. Now, acknowledging that you need to be healed.
Acknowledges the, you know? That's the first step.
Accepting.
But, you getting to the part where you're acting. Because the first step is like, once you've acknowledged and all that stuff, you're aware. You're now finding ways, practices on how to stop that cycle, to stop that habit. It takes work to get to that point, though. So, like.
Right.
You're not going to get it on your first shot.
No, but see, that's not. Why, I mean, but everything that we're talking about right now is not something that you wake up and then you start doing tomorrow.
So
I mean,
that's
you
what
start,
I'm saying.
You
got
to
like,
take, you got to, every day you got to take that conscious of like, you know what? Today I'm going to try to do something okay. different. Here. Today I'm going to do this with my kid. Today I'm going to, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to,
I got,
you know?
I got one better. So when I went back to Tennessee this past July, right? I had a very heart-to-heart conversation with my uncle. And he looked me dead in my eyes. And he said, I'm glad you didn't turn out how like your father.
Mm. Mm. Wow. That's-
and when he told me that, I said, Uncle David, you might not know this, but at a young age, I already knew I was never going to end up. From right. what I've seen and from how I was living, I was like, ain't no type of way.
The part right. where you got close to that.
Yeah,
but you caught yourself. So it's a matter of you being self-aware too, because that's the only way that you're get like going back to the whole like porn thing. How to talk to your kids and when about the whole subject, or like even how to set the tone of like what type of dynamic you want with your kids. That all goes with like how you feel about yourself,
right?
How you carry yourself,
right?
So if you don't know how to handle your own emotions, your kids are not going to be able to handle their own emotions because all they're seeing is how you can't handle your emotions.
We got some fucking bars. Clue bombs. Like, what's the fuck?
No, I just didn't want to ruin it.
Get them sound money, effects bro. In, bro. On, we've been bro. Dropping gems like
that. I got you.
All right.
Like,
what the hell? Sad music.
Bro.
All right. This is what we're doing.
No, that's what
we're doing. We got to change the whole soundtrack. It's a work in progress. No. But man,
cause like even what she said, and sorry to stay on this topic long, but I take this shit personal because it's just like, you never know when a child is watching you, bro.
Right.
So they could emulate that. Right. If a child sees you,
they say kids
you know,
are always
beating
watching.
On your wife, in his
watching.
Mind, he think that's right.
Right.
But as a child grows up and see that shit's wrong, it's the child's choice to be like, cool. Now, don't get me wrong. Inside that child, he's seen that, so there could be a situation where a chick pushes him to deep end and he lashes out like that.
Right.
Let's now, take it to the extreme, though. Let's talk about a white kid that's race, like grown up with
racist?
Like racist parents.
I wasn't
going
to take it there just yet.
No, let's get like that deep.
Okay.
No, right?
Let's go.
We're talking about the whole nature versus nurture thing, right? So, in the sense that okay, you're growing up around parents, right, that hate black people.
Right.
Any type of, any color that is not white, right? When you grow up, do you think there's a part of you that knows it's wrong, or do you have to be told other information to know that it's wrong?
Okay.
Whoever wants to go first with that.
Because
I don't have the answer.
I spent some time in the South. I don't have the answers either. I spent some time in the South, like Tennessee type shit.
Okay.
You feel me? I feel like it's a little bit of balance of both. Because I've been around people on both sides.
Okay.
I've been around racist white people. And I've been around white people who grew up in a racist household, but they know the wrong of that. So they choose to be...
like willfully ignorant.
Willfully... you know,
yeah,
yeah, it's like, oh, of course, yeah, oh, I don't see you color, blah, blah, blah. This is my black friend, this is my Hispanic friend, Asian friend, blah, 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 this and that. These are my racist parents. I know it's wrong, I don't want to grow up like that. And then you have your hardcore at a infant toddler hate niggers, hate black people, hate this, hate that, because it's beaten onto their subconscious to the point they think it's right, just like American History X, that movie.
Absolutely.
So until that nigga went to jail and seen, oh, these niggas is actually really cool.
If a kid can be conditioned to that extreme, can they be conditioned to fully trust their parents and come to them for any and everything?
Well, I guess my biggest thing is more so, do you know when something's intrinsically wrong? Right? You might be taught something or grow up around something.
Do you think
there's like a feeling like...
I remember being young and riding with one of my aunts, right? One of my aunts driving through LA
real quick.
Driving through LA.
And, right there.
And some like I don't know, I think she was like Indian or Chinese or some shit, right? She was Asian.
Yeah.
And then This is how black people get. She's like,
I didn't even know the story, but I'm laughing.
She's like, you fucking Buddha head, and I was like maybe 7 or 8. You know what I mean? And
I felt wrong
never
though, right?
Nobody never
did it feel
that.
Wrong like when you heard like, it. Like, I was like,
first of all, like that, I know that ain't right. Like, how do we even know that she fucked? I was just like, that don't even sound right. You know what I mean? I knew what was right and what was wrong. Like, if you see somebody getting bullied, you know what I mean? Put it like this: the kid who watches The Lion King and cries, you know right. You have a sense of right and wrong from a very young age.
And mind you, we're saying this from the opinion that we don't understand this at all. That's why I'm asking these questions.
These are the only examples that I can give. You see, I wanted to tear up. I remember watching Lion King the first time. I was like tearing up when fucking Mufasa died, and fucking Simba was, hey, wake up. I was like, shit. This is fucked up.
They fucked up.
So you know you have a sense of, you have a, like at an early age between, you know, 4 or 5, even maybe 3 years old, you know that a child can experience empathy, sympathy, remorse. You know what I mean? Happiness.
Anger. Sadness.
You know what I mean? Sadness.
And they're all innocent because they don't know.
Because they don't, you know, exactly.
Right.
So, nah.
Damn, man.
Honestly, I feel like the same way that there's people out there that are NPCs and they don't have a soul, it works.
I'm sorry, NPCs for the uninitiated over here. So I'm not initiated.
Not
here.
Initiated.
Non-playable characters in life that are just...
Oh, it's a gaming term. Okay, we got you.
NPCs matter, by the way.
All right.
They matter.
NPCs.
NPCs.
Okay. Yeah. I was like, NPC. I was like, we making like, beats?
No, it's like, no. I was like Googling. I'm like, Google like, said,
we got a mixer over there.
Basically, people that's caught up in the Matrix or that's part of the Matrix. Like,
that's another time.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
A whole rabbit hole, but.
But like, you know, there's kids, there's people, individuals in general that like, you can tell they don't have a soul. And then there's ones where I feel like you can tell they were born with some type of inner knowing. Like, I feel like the ones you notice that the most are the rebellious ones. Because those are the kids that came here and said, I already know what my purpose is. Like, their soul knows what their purpose is. But, like, everybody else kind of already sets the tone of, like, how they're going to condition based on environment and everything. You know what I'm saying? Right. Like, adults kind of set the tone of, like, no, you're a child, so you listen to us, da-da-da-da.
What do you call the kids that don't have that sociopaths?
So no,
is it?
Wait, you started to ask the question and then you said the word.
I'm making sure before I ask the question. Okay. Is that the term sociopaths? Right, where they don't have what you're describing.
A soul. Okay.
Their lack of empathy, sympathy.
It's almost like they're disconnected so much where it doesn't really matter. They don't have that.
Definitely a personality disorder. I don't know if it's classified generally as.
So a psychopath is born and a sociopath is made. A psychopath is someone that doesn't have their own emotions, but they basically learn off of society, like off of other people's emotions and stuff, like
cues. So they copy people's emotions to make their own character.
Exactly. Gotcha. And they make their own personality by that. But like a sociopath is someone that they grew up with their own, you know, set of feelings. They grew up like experiencing certain things, absorbing that. And then it's usually caused by like a traumatic situation.
Right.
That causes them to dissociate with their
feelings,
their emotions. So it's like, that's like a lot of people that are like cold hearted, like they don't seem to have any type of heart whatsoever, but like
dark skinned niggas. Black Air Force energy niggas.
Black.
But
gutter. Just say gutter.
NBA YoungBoy fans.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
So if we're talking about like kids technically didn't know better, quote unquote, I feel like that's like the Jeffrey Dahmers of the world, psychopaths, like they don't have their own true emotions, so they could like get away with
he's a psychopath.
That type.
I do not watch that.
But then there's
not a social psychopath.
Right. But then there's people that have gone through some type of traumatic, like some PTSD as a child or whatever. They might not even remember it. That's the worst part. So it's like unbeknownst to them that they even have like that type of a problem. They're a little bit more they're usually like more erratic though, too. Like they don't have like a stable life, usually, sociopaths. So like sociopaths still have their own emotions, technically, arguably.
Okay. It actually says,
Did we find out?
Looking at Psychology Today, it says, refers to a pattern of antisocial behaviors and attitudes, including manipulation, deceit, aggression, and a lack of empathy for others.
That's described as a Pisces from what other people
A little longer, but essentially, they're emotionally disconnected from other people, is what it's saying. Wow, that is... Okay. But, yeah. Something there.
Oh, you good?
Mm. Yeah. So
we're learning some interesting stuff.
It's actually really dark.
Yeah.
Take it where you want. I was like, after hearing that,
bad.
I didn't think it was that dark. So I was like,
so all in, I'm trying to bring it back because I'm like, what was the original fucking point?
Okay. Let me ask you this.
All webs that tie into this.
Yeah. Right. No.
If you were raising a sociopath,
right,
what would you do? How would you handle that? Someone that's emotionally disconnected to all the things you're talking about.
I think one of my nephews might be a sociopath. I'm going to be honest with you.
Have you ever seen Dexter?
Yeah.
If you're raising Dexter, how would you do it?
He's a psychopath.
Because I have a nephew. Like he knows he's coming to a birthday party and he's like, he has to wait and be told to say happy birthday. And it's just like, and then once he gets going, like, it's like, all right, now I'm at a birthday party and stuff. And I'm just like, food, you know, been at this party for like 30 minutes already. And most kids would just, oh shit, jumper, balloons, cake, and be excited. He's like, you know what I mean?
I mean,
I feel him, but personally, I don't.
These are around people that he knows though. You know what I'm saying?
So he's just naturally disconnected.
I don't know if you can fix psychopathy because that's a born thing, like that's a genetic thing and they're still trying to figure that out, but I think the way that you can address sociopathy, because those are people that are made, is you have to figure out what is this, like the root cause of it. Like you have to figure out what their trauma is. I think it's the parents, I think it's the upbringing,
it's the traumatic experience,
but that might not have even happened in the hands of when the parents had them, you know what I'm saying,
but during that years. During the years that you would be under the care of your parents. You know what I mean?
Your adolescence. Bro, your jit could have seen a dead person on the road and like not said anything about it, gone home, and your parents would never know.
Right.
The only way that could actually be figured out is like through different forms of therapy. And like one of them is like hypnotism, because it could not even be, like the child itself could have blocked that out of their memory to the point that they don't, even as an adult, they don't remember that that actually happened. So they don't even know why the way they are the way they are
That's facts.
Damn. Yeah. That is accurate, but
no. Clue bomb.
A little dark.
Yeah. Hey, drop them bombs, dog.
Bro, I'm fine. I'm trying
to find it. Guys, we'll get it together very soon.
That was good.
What was this?
Dramatic sound.
What was that?
You gotta hit it again so it'll stop, because it's gonna say it.
They're frying us up in the comments right now.
Press and hold, fool. Stop it.
We're looking for a sound producer.
Yes, please contact us.
Read the bottom of the screen right here.
Yes, we are sociopaths.
Call the 1-800 number.
We are sociopaths.
1-800-888-888. Call me now.
Call me now for your bum look like reading.
Hey, did you guys see? I've seen it on HBO Max. There's a Call Miss Cleo. I don't know if it's a documentary or a movie. Do y'all remember that shit? That's
thing I ever saw when I moved here to America. Miss Cleo. Y'all know, I was born and raised in Zimbabwe. And when I came here, Miss Cleo was the first commercial I ever saw.
That's funny.
Call me now.
Call me now for your free reading.
There's another guy. Pastor Kearney Thomas.
Bro, he had me donating 6 cents to like the same country I came from. This does not add up.
Did you ever receive money?
No.
Are you sure?
No, I'm still waiting on that stimulus, bro.
Bro, I'm still paying $6.
It's like the kid with the fly on his eyelid,
that
bro.
That pissed me off so bad, bro. As I got older, I'm like, y'all really let that off on TV.
Y'all gonna let a whole fly just stay there, right there.
Didn't you notice as we get older, it's like, god damn, bro.
Cold-blooded.
Some cold-blooded shit right there.
You need to call the fund. Who was those people? What's the name of that company?
I can't remember.
You never remember the Blue Cross of America?
I was so traumatized that I suppressed it deep in my consciousness.
You see, that's exactly what I'm talking about.
And that's how you become a sociopath. That's right there.
No, seriously, though.
No, actually, it still happened to this day. I saw it last night. Like, when I woke up, infomercial was still going on.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Dude, like
what a
you
finesse.
Have preachers
running the same place.
Getting money, like,
broken,
God
will
bless you if you bless me. And you're like, how do you work like this? You know what I mean? Like, it's still going on. Hey, apparently it works.
You know what that is?
What's that?
Your conscience.
What is it called? Telethons?
Telethons.
Do they still do that?
They do. Sadly, they do. I didn't know they still did it.
They did one for the church channels. No.
TBN.
TBN.
They did one for COVID.
Tabernacle Network. That's what it stands for.
They did one for COVID. I remember, bro. It was crazy.
Tabernacle Network.
Someone got triggered.
Oh, you're what?
I think he got triggered.
He's laughing. Because he knows it's true. He's Christian. My dad watches that shit. That's like BET inspiration, bro.
No, my family was like biggest. Mind you, I am still Christian, right? It's just the type of Christianity is so different.
What's the level of Christianity?
Do you guys yell? Do you guys... Do you guys do all that?
Well, I'll say this.
That was good.
That was actually really good.
Within Christianity.
That's just black church. That was black church, that was black church.
So what did they do on African church?
First of all. Damn, bro. I gotta put them on blast here. Okay.
Do you guys ride in on zebras?
Looks like
no, only on the weekends.
Do you consider an elephant a Hummer?
No.
It's luxurious.
A cheetah, it's more so like a Hyundai.
A Ferrari, though.
A like everyone's got one. Ferrari. Everyone's cheetah got Ferrari. One. It's a Hyundai. Yeah. Essentially.
Joey. Damn. How are you not talking when Haitians are the closest to Africa?
You ain't seen Black Panther 2, huh?
Jesus Christ,
Wakanda.
Bro.
You ain't seen Wakanda forever? They were in Haiti, bro.
Actually, if you think about it, Africans are the ones that didn't get captured, right? So we gave y'all up. And was like, well, good luck.
No, look.
Yeah. You
so essentially, so y'all were like the non-elite.
What it was is that they got to us first, and they was like, shit, these are all the niggas we need. We got the whole coast. They didn't need to go to East Africa, get the Ethiopians and shit.
I think we're good here. I think they
might have needed to go over there, though.
If we're on that topic,
aren't you conquered?
What if you woke up back in the past when that shit was happening?
I know it's easy, right? It's very easy to say.
I just thought about something. Think about the food for thought. Okay, we were got by the Americans or some of the British
people brought out French, here. Yeah.
But see, if imagine, would we still be slaves if we were under British control?
Yes.
No.
Would we have been slaves?
Yes.
Were y'all slaves over in y'all was?
We were. Well, the thing is about the British is what made America.
I might sound stupid right now.
No. What I'm saying is British are essentially what made America a thing.
Right.
Right. Because you had British were just naturally rebellious. If shit didn't work for them, they were willing to go. We're done with it.
Punk rock. Kinda,
yeah. So actually, without the British, I don't know I could say that we wouldn't still be slaves to this day.
Okay, so back to what I was saying, though. Mm-hmm. If you woke up a slave back in that time, during this time period that we are in now,
okay,
you just wake up and, god damn it, whoosh, Right in the back. That's, that's your introduction.
Annabella. What is it? It's a movie called Antebellum.
Yes. Yep. That's a great
movie. That was a trip.
Jordan Peele, right?
Yep. No.
Jordan Peele?
He produced it. Not directed.
Jordan Peele.
Yeah. He produced it.
So there's a movie like that.
Yeah. She woke up and it's a twist.
Oh.
Did you watch it? No.
We're not going to tell it.
But I'm asking, did you watch it, Annabellum?
I'm pretty sure I did.
She woke up black or white.
What's homegirl's name?
She was black. And she's Kate like woke up like back in the day,
but after the back in the day traumatic experience, she woke up white.
I can't ruin it.
No, she didn't ever woke up white.
No, don't ruin it. No, okay. that's the point.
That's not a
spoiler alert. Like, don't say anything.
Okay, nope.
Yeah.
All right. Like the fault, like there's false scenes in the trailers and shit.
Say no, don't do
that's,
it.
That's she turned white.
Okay, so she turned white. How would you react if you woke up back in that day,
bro? I think I'd die.
You're just off yourself.
I think all of us would die.
I don't know because it'd be. What the fuck was that?
Yeah.
Bro.
First reaction, bro.
Come here, nigga.
Man, who the fuck is this nigga calling me a nigga? Bro, who the fuck?
I know you ain't about to call me out for picking up. I literally cleared out all this cotton already. Right. And
as soon as I hear a whip crack, bro, I'm like, what the fuck? Like,
you already know what the fuck time going on, bro. Ain't no iPhones here, nigga.
I can see on the auction block. 6'4", he's got a bit of an attitude. all right, we'll start the bidding here at $50.
Okay. $50.
$20.
Boy. Yeah.
$10. See, free.
You know, $3.
They would have looked at that scar on your knee and they would have been like,
he's damaged.
Right over the head.
Like, he works over hard.
What did they say in Django? He works hard.
He's been through it.
Damaged goods.
He's been through the fields already.
Nah.
This guy doesn't know what cotton is. That's crazy.
No. Hell no. If I woke up and it was slavery days, bro, I would die because I wouldn't be accustomed to the times. I'd just be like, yo, nigga, get out there. Fuck you, nigga.
Depending on.
I'd be calling them niggas.
G shit. Depending on.
Nigga, who you talking to, bro? Fuck out of here.
Nah, I feel like, depending on how I wake up, hopefully I wake up sleeping and I'm like, oh shit, I'm in a goddamn barnyard full of niggas. Oh yeah, we off the master, bro. Straight up. But if I'm woke up in mid whip,
we're also making the assumption that we're getting woke up in the middle of the day. No. You know, when does slave life start?
When do they get a break?
There is no break. They don't. You don't work.
Like, do they not sleep? And if they did, how many hours? Because we never know, bro. This is some of the things.
You didn't have sleep like, science like back 12 there either.
So no, it was sun up to sun down. 5:30 in the morning to whenever the sun went down.
See, the problem is, Brandon, though, you'd be indoors, though, because you're really light-skinned.
House, right? Nigga, for sure.
So there's no way you're in the fields.
No.
I'm just saying. There's no way.
Yeah. Would you be the fields, bro? What are you talking about?
Oh, I would be the byproduct of... The slave owner and the slave.
You might have a little room in the basement.
So y'all two washing dishes while me and my boy over here are literally out here.
I'm telling you, I don't know. That knee is questionable. They'd be sitting over there talking. I don't know about that one right
there.
Battle
tested. Like
he's got that knee. How'd you get that scar, boy?
Mama was super heavy. I had to be able to.
Kill.
Yeah. His back might give out.
No, I'll just do some rebellious shit. It just depends. I would have to off them niggas.
Hell nah.
Straight up.
I'd be trying to, first day one, I woke up in slavery days, I'd be trying to get like, I'd be on some like rebellion. Yeah, I'd be trying to get A.
How long y'all been here?
Y'all trying to get out this bitch?
Y'all trying to get out this bitch?
Prison. Like, right, bro, prison break.
What you do? Yeah. How you get here? Yeah, how
much what you got? For,
I mean,
let me get that cornbread.
There was different types of house niggas too, because there was the house niggas that was gonna be like the ones I feel like actually plotting because they knew the ins and outs of the house, like how to get to the slave master.
That would be.
They had to be the what do you call it? The mediator between, you know, like
there was not. Right. Look, we are hoping. This is hopeful, wishful thinking.
No.
Hell no. You know, if we woke up in slavery days, we'd be right there with them niggas picking cotton for sure.
Hold on a second. That's what they, I'm sorry, I have to insert. That's what they want y'all to think, though.
Either I'm gonna die because I wouldn't catch up. You know what I mean?
No, like, do you know that there's,
don't get it. You know what I mean?
We could talk about Harriet Tubman, but you know that we won battles, right?
Oh, for sure.
Okay.
Now watch
Wait,
this.
Actually, talk about her sister, though. Remember the story with her sister? With the fact she was like, yo, you're doing all this stuff. And the sister saw everything she's doing.
And she was like, yo,
I'm not like you. I can't do this.
Well, see, and that's just died.
And that's the
other side of the door.
It's
because
dark.
You would think that because these Negroes are in the house, that they can, they're privy to information that can help us Negroes out in the, or not, I guess I'm with you guys.
Right.
Because of tenure.
But no, you are. Be clear. You're indoors. Yeah, right. Be clear.
You are a house Negro.
What she's saying, you would think that you niggas would hope that us niggas will give them some information on how to get out this shit.
Well, actually, you know, I'm pretty sure this is the actual movie where there's a plot of like,
Django.
The reality is, like Samuel L. Jackson's character is that y'all niggas ain't finna fuck my life.
He's a great example.
You niggas
gonna let him in the big house,
bro?
Master, no.
All right, that nigga got shot. He was yelling with his tongue out his mouth.
I got one for you,
heavy,
which will be a great segue to the next. What would Kanye do if he woke up a slave? Since you know slavery was a choice. Oh, yeah.
Number one would not last 2 minutes. Like it's done. Oh. It's just done.
Kanye would like mid sentence
I don't have all the answers, man.
Billy club mid sentence. So look, man, I was just saying that y'all need to stop doing. Boop. Mm. They dropped the nigga.
If I had $30 billion, if I had $30 billion, and I offered you, no. I said, hey, this $30 billion is yours, but for 30 days you have to be a slave in today's society. But you have to go. But they treat you like. Back in the day,
it's like, oh, I'll take it. No. Easy.
So that's you're picking cotton, you're
light
getting
work.
Whipped.
I call that 30 light
million.
Work.
Is that a yes. million? If you said bro, top days for 30 million?
I know myself. Most people aren't built for it. I can easily do it. Light work.
$1 million.
I call that light work. Yeah. A week?
Bro.
To be a slave. Week?
Bro.
That, a real slave. Salary. I'm not talking about.
Bro,
I'm talking about physical,
easy.
Out in the sun, cotton picking.
Light work.
You're getting thrown in the hot house.
Shut the fuck up and do my job.
You talked to the wrong person about this one.
That's what I'm saying. I'm like, aren't your parents African?
I was about to say, this is really light work.
How did you get...
What was the hard... Okay, Tandy, what was the hardest job you ever had to do in Africa?
In Africa or here? Actually, the hardest job I had was here.
Bench
press
elephant.
Hardest job I did in Africa. Sorry. Actually, I had no hard jobs in Africa.
Easy life.
Most of them was like selling shit on the street, like traffic lights.
Third world country problems.
I did that a couple times.
At traffic lights?
Hell yeah, bro.
That we do it selling,
here.
Though.
What was you
hardest
selling?
Hardest jobs were here.
Flowers.
You selling drugs?
No.
He was
bananas,
selling flowers, bro.
Cool, fake Kool-Aids.
Lean?
Yeah. No. That's too expensive.
Dang.
Yeah, hydro. Yeah.
I saw a documentary.
Started
on
from
that
the
shit.
Bottom.
Like,
now
God,
we're here.
Damn, y'all got it way out
but
there.
But here, though, uh-huh. hardest job I ever had, I'll tell you the two.
McDonald's.
I used to sell makeup door to door.
Oh.
That shit was different.
You were one of them. What brand was
it? Oh, I killed it. But top seller. Myself too, because my self esteem went down like crazy.
So many.
I got literally.
Who's this nigga at my door?
One out of 20 people.
Right.
It was rough.
Were you the only black guy working there?
Yes,
I knew it.
Yeah.
What was this? Texas.
But choose my self esteem went up like crazy after that because rejection was just
easy.
Yeah.
Sales will do that to you.
Ah, dude.
And you're a Cancer. You're soft. So the fact that you're taking rejection good is a good thing.
Well, I'm also soft. Good at numbers. I was like, yo, the more I get rejected.
Statistics show.
But I was like, fuck.
You're using statistics at your own advantage.
Yeah, it hurt. That was the worst. And then I did telemarketing for on hold call messaging. So when you call a company, hey, welcome to blah, 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 blah.
Mm-hmm.
So I used
scammers
to
are us.
So compared to us right now, given the climate, do you think that Kanye West's job right now is one of the hardest in the world?
Being married.
Trying to dig himself out of this mess that he's gotten himself into.
Actually, you know
what?
Let me rephrase it.
He's trying to dig himself out of a mess that he got himself.
I think he's going to come to the realization that I did a bunch of fuck shit and I might need to apologize for this.
Well, the thing is,
he's not apologizing for shit.
He's unapologetic.
I think you have to be him though to be able to handle that. There's no way you're normal and deal with the things he's doing. Like it just doesn't make any sense. For example, like you're saying right now, right? All the criticism that he's getting. We can't handle that.
That's also criticism he brought on by himself.
To be able to handle that.
That's like tripping. No, that's like kind of like bullying. That's like doing something stupid and expecting somebody not
to
say tell you something.
You have to be so disassociated to be able to ignore everything.
Okay, specifically, what are you saying is stupid though? Like that he did.
No, I'm not saying anything that he said. Well, I mean,
everything he says.
It's a lot of shit that he said.
I think it's just how he says it. Like what he's saying is not actually like wrong. It's just how he says it. It rubs people the wrong way. Just like
be careful.
His delivery. And stuff.
I was like, if he's speaking out.
Where we going? I see this shit coming from a mile away.
Okay.
How y'all feel about Kyrie?
Okay.
Oh, see, all right, we're going into this. All right.
No,
look,
it's the same, ooh, it's the same cloth, all right?
We're gonna, are we going to talk about the
Woozy? Break us in. Say the How do you feel about Kyrie?
Kyrie's doing his thing. He knows who he is. Great baller, get buckets, winning championship for Brooklyn.
No,
doing good.
No,
he's,
absolutely,
he's
not.
Never going to win a championship.
He's never going to win a championship. He doesn't have Kyrie doesn't have the. He's too distracted. He doesn't have a GOAT mentality. He doesn't know how to put.
Wait. Let's be clear here. Right. Does LeBron have a GOAT mentality?
Yes.
Okay, just being clear.
Yes.
Because I know people like
GOAT mentality. I mean,
as in.
What do you mean by that?
I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna tell you this.
I was like, let's be clear here.
Hey, drop some sounds on that. I need. Yeah. What do you mean? By that? Mentality, wrong sound.
To literally, to be the best.
Yeah. I don't know what sound.
Sorry. People in the comments just let. Oh, you know what? Yeah.
No.
Actually, whichever sound you prefer, just let us know in the comments.
No. GOAT mentality.
Okay. What's the GOAT?
To put aside, to focus so much on your craft and what you're doing that you put, that you put aside. No. It's not about basketball. It's not about basketball.
Okay.
But he just doesn't. And to put aside all the shit, distractions, and focus on your craft and be the best at that. It's something that's getting you paid for. This is your dream. And now you get to your dream and you have all these distractions and you have these excuses why you can't be the best at your craft. I hate to say to shut up and play basketball, but I think you've gotten so distracted and caught up into life that you forgot your role. And now it's affecting your team.
Maybe
and teammates.
Maybe he wants his own show like Kaepernick.
Then choose. You have to choose.
A show?
Yeah.
He does. He had like a Netflix. Yeah. I watched it. It's pretty dope.
All right. Yeah. You ready? You ready for some real shit? Could I chime in?
Wow. Let's do it.
All right. Deep down inside, Kyrie don't give a fuck about basketball. listen to where I'm coming from.
I'm hearing you. I got you.
All right. Watch. I'll put it to you like this. So
he's the most skilled of all time.
This is entertainment. We're here wasting our time watching talented people play basketball for our entertainment.
True.
Agreed.
Whatever time a basketball schedule is, and these are the popular teams, people are paying
to be entertained.
Yeah.
I could get very deep into this. Because it's like, I'm sorry, I'm talented, and I know how to use my talents to make millions of dollars, and then I came to a point in life where I'm understanding that most of this shit really doesn't matter.
Yeah, honestly.
But I'm going to benefit of this. But to say shut up and play basketball,
no.
Then you have niggas like LeBron, no offense or anything like that, that's going to shut up and play basketball because you're getting paid mad money.
And he getting paid by the white people them.
No.
And all these people to carry this notoriety and prestige for the league.
So
Kyrie ain't with that.
Okay, so choose a side. My thing is like be... Look,
that's tough,
bro. I hear what you're saying. I hear what he's saying. Be that guy. Fuck all that. Drop the team.
I'll put it. Boom. I love how you did that. I'll put it to you like this.
Leave. Retire. Use what you've already accomplished now.
Wait, why wouldn't you do that if you're Kyrie? Why wouldn't you do that if you were Kyrie?
Oh, he stops his income?
It's very easy to have crazy opinions when you in a position of advantage.
He could
it's
be
very
like
easy.
So many people in his family. He can't just cut some off like that.
Exactly.
So I'm going to use my talents knowing that I'm going to get paid to help other people and my family, knowing that at any given moment, I could say fuck this shit because y'all are criticizing me about my thoughts, my beliefs, and what my religion is because I'm finding myself.
The thing is about Kyrie. And he's uniquely in this position that he's actually one of, if not the most, just talented as far as skill.
Ball handling.
Skill level. Skill level in general.
Right. Of course.
He's arguably the most skilled NBA player of all time.
Of course.
Which means Swiss he dedicated Army. So much time to it. So to say, this guy's been doing this since
a very young age.
And now, like I said, you get to the NBA, now you have all the, where was all this philanthropy when you were in college?
He didn't know because he was young, because he was conditioned to play basketball at a young age.
So you got to this awakening moment.
Yeah.
And then you want people to understand you while you're letting your people who are taking the job that you practice your whole life for serious.
That's exactly where I was going.
You know what I mean? Now, okay, find yourself. Go find yourself. Leave us out of it, because we're dedicated. We're in the gym shooting.
But he goes,
you want to take your break and be out and be on your beliefs.
So basically you're saying you want a ball player to stay as a ball player and they can't go without, with like outside of that.
There's a time and a place. Oh, no, there's a time and a place.
No. Okay, but then we could say the same for Kaepernick, because Kaepernick goes in that same category. He was trying to do everything for the movement and everything. You know what I'm saying? He started everybody doing the kneeling and all that.
I think you're both right in the sense that Kyrie's not built for that. Kaepernick was.
Right.
Kyrie's thoughts are not well thought out.
Flat earth.
And the thing is, the problem with Kyrie is that he makes us seem like his thoughts are like the entire, like the movement's thoughts.
So then it comes down to wording. It's the same thing as Kanye. Like, just because what he's saying rubs y'all the wrong way does not mean that it's wrong. And just because of the way that he's saying it, making y'all uncomfortable, doesn't mean that
what it is with them is like once they get the information, they don't do enough research. They just get the piece of it and
you know who else did that shit?
Agreed.
Nick but that's Cannon what makes him a ball player and not a researcher.
And then look. And then they retrace what they said, do further knowledge information, and get you know the correct answers in order to go deeper and find themselves within. Because with the Kyrie situation, it's just like, nigga, he was born in the 90s just like us. He's a product of,
who's us, bro? I'm 89, bro.
I don't know what. Oh, yeah.
My bad,
bro. Young boy?
Yeah. Y'all got gray hair. My bad. My bad, bro. Got gray hair on your balls and shit.
I had a pager one time.
Right. No, the big block phones. Remember those?
Bro.
Look, Skytel, the big boom box walking down the street. That was us, 2 years old, fam. What you talking about?
I'm sorry. Pager.
Yeah, go ahead. You got it. We won't make a tangent.
Wow. He's like, youngin.
Go ahead, youngster.
Yeah. But like I was saying, though, it's like the older he got, he's trying to find himself. Like he's on social media, knowing that he's, you know, part of a Native American tribe, knowing this, knowing that, getting more exposed because this. It's like, I'm sorry that I'm talented and I was conditioned in order to do this. But it's then again, I have to utilize this sport to feed my people and family. But then again, I'm still trying to learn about myself because there's a deeper meaning, because it's all distractions, bro.
There's nothing wrong with that.
He's not wrong in the sense that what he's saying, you're right. What I'm saying is he's not fully informed.
Yeah.
But the problem is he has so much influence on the culture. He's just putting shit out there without actually doing the research. And
so are we more upset about the fact that he has so much influence, or are we upset about the fact that he has a platform to speak about shit that he feels like he should be able to speak about?
But the platform, because
hold on.
Go for it.
Because I was going to say that we could say the same thing about celebrities when it comes to politics. Like, y'all let celebrities tell y'all who to fucking vote for. They don't know shit about shit. They're literally, like, a lot of them are idiots.
But then there are celebrities who are actually really smart and dark or are in politics.
But that's what I'm saying. The same way that you could.
In Hollywood.
So what I'm saying is the same way that you should be able to let a celebrity go outside, like,
out there.
Outside of their confinement is the same way that a ball player should be able to.
I get it. Now the thing is, the difference is, what if the actor, what if you were watching Avatar, right?
Oh God.
And Zoe Saldana in the middle of the movie said, hey, by the way, vote for Joe Biden. And then went on back to the fucking thing. Would you like that?
Okay, I see what you're saying.
You got to choose a side and know when you can't.
It's just when to say things and how to say it.
It's not even that. Have your beliefs, but your beliefs are coming at the expense of your teammates right now. You know what I mean? It's like find your voice, bro. Nobody's faulting you, but are you going to be a part of the team or are you going to find your voice?
Because
you
can't do both. Watch this. Ready?
Because you're missing practice. You're missing games. Uh-huh. You're not playing with us. Mm-hmm. What are you doing? How are you helping? And how are you helping yourself?
Okay, so this is just me speaking as far as me. I'm already a champion. Fuck the team.
What is that? What you're saying? So Kyrie?
That's what I'm saying.
Wait, hold on. Let him say it.
He can, if he wanted to.
Oh my God!
But he's not gonna fuck up the bread for future generations and what he already has going on. Because if you keep critiquing him and you push, because like think about it like this: he's one of the most controversial basketball players to play the game.
He's literally the most gifted. As far as skills.
I'm saying
skill
controversial. Yes. Because the COVID thing, the shot thing, the Jewish thing, and skill. His skill, what people love and be like, all right, let's sweep that under the rug. Oh, he said that. Let's sweep that under the rug. Because his skill is captivating the people's entertainment.
And that was Kanye West for so long.
Right.
Now, I haven't heard anything. Well, Kyrie Irving.
Actually, honestly,
the only thing I heard about Kyrie Irving is this man's getting buckets right now.
Wait, but what?
And they sweeped everything underneath the rug with all that stuff. Just to throw that out there.
Exactly.
But he spoke his mind and said what he has to. I guarantee if there's another pandemic or some shit happened again and he were to speak up for himself, it would be like, all right, we're going to trade him and this and that. He would have been in the position to be like, all right, fuck it, I retire.
Well, that's the thing, though. It's not even about basketball at that point. It's more so about business and the fact that sales cures all. Kyrie gets people in. Kyrie gets buckets. It's that simple.
Entertainment.
Man, if I was a business owner, 1,000% I would sign Kyrie. I wouldn't sign for more than a year at a time. Exactly. I'll give him what he wants. Exactly. Whatever. I'll give you $100 million if you want.
That ain't shit, because that's 10%
a year at a time.
Exactly.
I would never tie myself to him. But yeah, 100%, because he brings people in, and just at the end of the day.
It's all media propaganda and emotional.
He is a superstar whore.
But he's so good. He's literally all time. He's all time.
I get it. I get it. But do you think everything that he's been going through and put himself through is going to keep him from reaching the ultimate success?
Which is what to him? What's his ultimate success?
I don't know. Whatever that means. I mean, as a to win the most champions, I don't fucking
know.
Thinking
as a basketball player,
is the most gifted at the most influential position of all time. Period.
So Kyrie it sounds like he's accomplished everything that he needs to accomplish.
I didn't say accomplished, but I'm saying gifted as far as the talent, natural talent.
Yeah.
Kyrie is it's not even close.
That doesn't mean anything if you're out here saying stupid shit.
Agreed. What I'm saying, as far as natural talent on the court,
it's not even close. I feel like I gotta be like caught up.
Like, what does he say? Stupid shit?
What's
flat earth?
Earth is flat.
Yeah. Earth is flat. That's so stupid. Yeah.
All right, I'm not even
gonna
get into
that. That's a great start, actually. Yeah.
But
you just ended there, just like, earth is flat.
But
so do you think that the world is a globe?
I think it's a sphere.
You think it's a sphere, like how they tell you it is?
Like how we've based off NASA images.
NASA?
Yeah.
Do you know what NASA was before it was in space?
Based off skydiving, actually.
They used to study the sea. So whatever they found in the sea, it completely altered their whole goals, their whole setup to where they're like, oh, no, we're going to the sky. Like, we're going to outer space now to figure out where we can go now instead of staying on Earth, because whatever they saw down there, what do you call it?
Are you saying there's a possibility that the world is flat?
I'm saying that
it's not shaped to what people say it is. It could be flat depending on where you're looking from.
I'm gonna say this.
You see what Kyrie started?
The images of the continents in the world that we're seeing could be smaller or larger.
I'm gonna just say this. There's a lot of ancient.
Nonetheless, it's a sphere, not flat,
guys. We've seen it. There's way too much out there. We've seen it.
There's a lot. There's a lot of ancient evidence that points more towards it being more flat rather than a globe how we see it. So what I'm saying is it could be more like dome-like, because there's a lot of images.
Okay, I agree.
A lot of images, because I'm not necessarily a flat Earth theory person. I'm definitely devil's advocate, but I've entertained every idea as well because I'm open-minded.
Do you see this right here?
That's a coaster. Yes.
It's round.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a circle.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
If you look at it from an aerial point of view, what's it look like? It's flat from an aerial point of view.
Agreed. So my question to you is, can you fall off the edge?
We don't know.
We do know because we've sailed
around the world. Okay, but haven't they said that?
That is the problem.
We've sailed around the world.
It's very easy to prove this.
And we have orbit. We have an orbit. We have an atmosphere.
They actually say that.
They actually see what Kyrie started? How he be getting his shit sometimes.
But I'm like, we have the technology. We do it every day. It's like, we can easily fall off the edge.
You guys are saying that.
You know what I mean?
Technically, physics can prove that the edge that we always see, we shouldn't be able to see that much if it was a sphere the way they say it's a sphere, if that makes sense.
It does. So it's
more so.
In that.
All right, where's that thing?
Are we getting
that,
in this?
It's more so like a donut, if anything, because there's a show on Netflix. It's called.
I was trying to transition, but you didn't start.
I will tell you
what.
And I know where you're going.
Nope, we're here now.
The thought, and I'll tell you why it's flawed.
The Earth is a fucking donut.
No. I was about to say, there's this show on Netflix. It's okay. called The Inside Job. And a lot of...
Oh, I've seen that shit. It's pretty fucking hilarious.
There is a lot of content in there, though. If you're listening to subliminals of it, yeah. there's a lot in symbolism. There's a lot of content in there, though, that's basically telling you what shit is, but saying in a joking manner so y'all don't take it seriously. What they introduce in there is not flat earth theory.
No.
Like they literally said they're trying to distract people with, but that it's a hollow earth. So if you're incorporating everything that you've culminated together in your research, right? It's more so like a donut. So it's hollow.
In the
middle. It has the rounded of a sphere.
Thank you.
But it also has that dome-like, flat-like theory.
So
you get what I'm saying?
Also, are we also going to say we got lizards living in the depths?
The reptilian people?
No. Yeah.
You're not wrong.
You think that the Star Wars came from? That's actually an ancient story from like the Kemet people. They're talking about the...
I'm not that well-versed.
I'm not...
Okay, so the name Anakin comes from the people, the Anunnaki people?
Yeah, I know that.
All right. Really? So that's... Yes, yeah, so...
Y'all done fucked up.
No, yeah, I didn't know that.
I genuinely did not know.
We got to save that.
But I'm just saying.
That's literally intro to the episode.
Yeah, that's
I fuck with it, though. I like it.
Fucked up. I'm like, I'm trying to keep y'all ADD-ass niggas on the same, on the right page.
I mean,
I'm like,
we actually always tie it back to the point.
Oh, no. And this is what Kyrie did with flat earth theory.
See how that is complete bullshit. Because the science, it doesn't make sense.
Okay. Here, I'm going to put it to you like this.
I suck at science. I know science a little bit, and I know it doesn't make sense the way he described it.
Right, because...
Make it make sense. Go for it.
This is how... I'm not saying the earth is flat. I'm just saying from the angle you're seeing it at on a sphere.
Correct. Level. As a coaster, for example.
As a coaster. If you're looking at it from an aerial point of view, from a distance, you're going to think it's flat because you can't see...
Can you fall off?
Can you? I've never fallen off the face of the earth. Have you?
Not that
personally,
I know.
Personally, there's so many different things like the Bermuda Triangle in different places of the world
that
keep like, there's almost like this magnet.
The center of the earth
thing.
Too and shit like that. We have different layers that we still haven't cracked and stuff like that. So it's just like literally depending on where you're seeing it from, it's just like a fucking pizza, bro.
Agreed. So can you just say the world is not flat though? By saying it's flat, you literally...
No, I never said it was flat. I'm just saying from where you're seeing from, people could be like, oh, it's flat.
Angles, yeah.
Just different angles. That's it. That's all I'm saying is just different angles. People might perceive it as different things.
See, this is what happens when we start talking.
just like a booty, though.
This is what happens when niggas get high. smoke this shit. Smoke the shit.
Why does that make sense?
Because.
Oh, gosh. Please make
for example, my ass is actually the perfect example.
Yes,
because it's not the biggest, roundest, or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
It's fat as fuck.
It's got a slant to it, though. So from a certain angle, I could look like I have no back whatsoever, like no body. You know what I'm saying? Oh, and then
like,
from
it's like,
another...
It's like white girls.
No, I'm laughing. Like, what?
And that's then from another angle, like, if you was to angle it up, I would have a whole lot of cheeks.
No,
so
it's
it really
like
is
all
like,
booties if you, matter. If you're watching, if it's like, if you're looking at a white girl walk towards you, like, okay, she kind of thick. And then she walks, she gets
and she
right,
turns to the side?
Right next
no,
to
no, no,
you.
No.
It's just like, ugh.
Perfect. I got you. Are you ready? Sink booty.
Sink booty.
That's a chick that sits on the sink, you never know. She sits on the sink, ass looks fat. She stands up and be like, are you fucking kidding me?
It's like, where did it all go?
Flat earth theory.
Explained.
Right there. It's
that's
perception.
So true.
It's from the angle.
You guys
put it in the comment section.
No,
if you
but
agree
here's
with
my
the,
thing, though.
Woozy.
Why are we trying, like, why do we believe the people that told us that it's a sphere when those are the same people that told us that Africa is apparently this small in comparison to all these other continents around it?
Because
the way that they portray it on the globe that we know that we learned growing up is not correct.
I'm going to tell you why I believe them.
You can fit three USAs.
I'm going to tell you why.
Yes.
In the continent of Africa.
Pangea.
Look, okay. I believe them because I can barely change the oil in my car.
This dude.
And they can put a motherfucker in space.
This motherfucker right here.
I'm sorry, but...
Brandon, I really thought you were going to say something.
I know. I was like,
help me.
Why I believe him. That's why I believe him.
Yeah.
That's why I believe him. I don't, bro. You put somebody in space. I believe.
Hold on.
Technology.
No, to go back to the point that we were talking about before, though.
Kyrie.
You believe the same people that put in effect you having to put your ID out to be able to watch porn for your own self-enjoyment.
I don't think NASA believe those same people. To do with those people.
No, no, no. They are. They all go in the same category. NASA works for the government. The government have their own little thing going on.
Yeah, because, bro,
they're
the
over here programming people. What are you talking about?
The satellite has to hit the signal in order to see.
They're programming and control. Yeah. What does that sound like?
The can of worms. This is a can of worms right now.
You know,
I love it, though. I don't know. I believe it because I don't know what else. If you don't believe in anything, believe in something. I don't know. And I believe...
That's terrible advice.
And the comments,
if you don't believe it...
In the comments, let us know what you believe in something.
Babies and kids, if you do not believe in anything, believe in something.
In the comments, let us know what you believe.
I don't think that that's how it goes.
Believe in...
You gotta believe in something.
Flat earthers, reptilian people, time travelers...
No, this is the... This
Atlantis, any conspiracy theory out there, just throw it in the comments. Let us know what you believe in. We'll dissect it.
True.
I love it.
Yeah. So on to the next subject, like I was trying to get to, where these ADD people just brought us into a rabbit hole and then a spider web that just brings us back. Another person that name that starts with a K, Kanye West, allegedly remarried. How do you guys feel about that?
He lies. He said it himself.
Okay.
He's such a fucking hoe.
He loves it.
He loves it. He loves it.
How do you pick someone? All right, let's say, you're a celebrity, right?
I love this. Here we go. Because I have the perfect answer.
It's so tough. I want to make sure I don't get canceled.
Just to let you know,
you got to ask it.
His wife is of a Kardashian
cloth.
Cloth. Yeah.
Okay.
Cut from the same cloth, no pun intended.
How do you know? Okay, first of all, if you're a millionaire and you're getting married, do you make your wife or her husband sign a prenup? Who wants to go first?
Are you asking if we're in the position of being a celebrity?
Like already
if,
in that
if
position?
If you're established, you're a millionaire,
right?
Would you make your wife or husband sign a prenup?
Before, get married?
Before I got this money?
No, I'm saying you got the money.
But you just now woman. Entering player one?
I wouldn't
Who
get
wants
married.
To go first?
I wouldn't get married.
Ooh. Yeah.
Explain. I wouldn't get married.
We rocking out because you ain't getting shit.
So you Oprah. Yep.
Huh?
You Oprah.
Yes.
You got a bunch of stebbins.
Hey, yeah, look, stebbins. For every woman, I need to get married. Well, Oprah didn't.
Right.
What? Why do I need to get married? Why do you need to get married? For what?
And y'all having kids before marriage anyway, so why y'all getting married?
Right. I'm not.
You gotta say it like that?
You gotta tie the knot to make it official.
I'm not saying I never want to get married.
I understand the position. I want to hear the thinking, though, behind it. Why?
Because I've made the money.
Without you.
Without you, exactly. You didn't make it with me. You are, because I like you, you're privileged to the lifestyle that I'm providing for you.
Ooh, I know.
You know what I mean? Mm.
To me?
So because I introduced you to a lifestyle,
you ain't gonna get nothing from me,
and then I break
me,
it off with you, you're entitled to continue to live that lifestyle? Mm. Why?
For what?
Mm, to me?
Yes.
Because that's what it all is about.
A prenup, like a for a wedding, around a wedding, gives me the same vibes as like, for example, like my parents taught me, don't lend your friends money. Like if you don't have that money to give them and don't expect it back, don't lend it, because that type of thing it'll fuck up a friendship.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I think the same concept happens with prenups. A prenup is you already having within your mind that this may not work out. And at that point, that means that you kind of feel like you may or may not be able to trust your partner.
That's fine.
You know what I'm saying?
So I
feel like, why do a prenup? Just don't get married, like you said.
Yeah,
straight up.
Yeah, don't get married. Because to me, it's like this. If I ain't had the money and you ride or die with me to where I make the money and then we end up
you deserve that.
Then you deserve that because you got my jit. You done been through here and this and that. And then, all right, well off, as long as you
So basically you're saying like if that person decides to fuck you over later, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can have that. You got that because
Hey,
earned it.
See, and that's where it's just like,
That's right there. That's why I asked the question.
Right. Because if you decide to fuck me over, it's like, goddamn, like this whole time. And then you just end up hitting me with the flim flam. It's really, like,
these are questions and I don't have answers to. You know what I mean?
Like, just stay with me if you want to be straight. Like, goddamn.
Right. If you are building with somebody and you like from the ground up, like you just described, why would you fuck that up?
Now,
what would be grounds of fucking that up?
Now, I'm going to say this.
Infidelity?
If I'm building it, and I get it, and I help you build it, and then you end up leaving, but the fact that I helped you build it, as long as I know you straight, I don't really got nothing to worry about, because it's like, you're on your own independent shit. What we had reconciled, this and that.
I think this is this a all if we have though.
A
jit though.
That is a different one. That's a different.
You're adding situation. An element of okay. Now they're good.
I help. Yeah, I help. I, so they deserve I made that. You good. I made you okay, good. Okay. You know okay. What I mean? Just, so yeah.
But like, if it's like y'all, I guess came, you know, came from the bottom.
Now we're here.
You know, type.
Do you
shit,
believe? So you guys? Do you guys believe in spousal the spousal support?
What do you mean?
So when you get, so if you get yes. if you get married and you guys divorce.
Yes.
You got us
dependent, but yes.
Wait. You believe in that?
If
wait, what?
The problem is, right? Spousal, a lot of situations where guys want to take care of the woman, which is cool.
Are
right?
you talking about like when a
in like a divorce, financially
in a divorce,
co-parenting?
Like child support for the woman, essentially,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, yeah. Oh.
So it's spousal more so support. If you have a situation where the woman has been staying at home, right? Not actually
right.
intentionally
and then the
making
man
money.
Wants to divorce
100%, I'm with it, right?
Right.
But most of the time, it's not that. It's most it's actually really abused.
Yeah.
Most of the times,
it is abuse.
Yeah,
you got a woman.
Are you talking on which side? Which like
it's abused more so.
Who's
from
the one
women's
abuses?
Perspective,
the women,
right?
Right?
But no, I believe women if you have an arrangement where she stays at the house and doesn't tangibly, quote unquote, make money.
Mm-hmm.
Right, like she doesn't
then,
have
yeah.
a 9 to 5.
100%.
She's not on any
W
2s, W 4 paperwork.
Exactly,
or anything
because
like
that's
that.
The agreement you have. She's taking care of the house, right?
House,
which matters a lot. It's not about the money; it's about the value that you're providing, right?
Absolutely.
So if she's doing that, then 100%, I believe in that.
Right.
Most of the times, it gets abused.
It's the 50s.
Right. Yeah. If you have a woman that submits to you in that level.
There you go again.
Personally, the only spousal thing, it, like he said, if y'all already had that dynamic where she was not basically allowed to make money when she wanted to. Because say she was a hustler, right? She gave up her career to be with you as a spouse.
Yeah.
And then you turn around and you'd be like, oh, I don't know if I want to be with you anymore. And then you're like, well, fuck, I could have been on my fucking
shit.
Right.
Shit. Exactly. Like, you yeah, yeah. definitely going to fund me. Like, that's how I'm going to feel in that situation.
Right, right, right.
But
right.
if it's a situation where it's like, okay, I gave that up or like you were taking care of me during that time. I have my little hobbies or whatever. I don't think as that person that already has that as my background, I wouldn't even want you to support me like that.
Right.
If we're cutting ties like that, I wouldn't want you to support me. I feel weird. Well, I feel like a kid.
I feel like, yeah. no, at the same time, though, you also sacrificed to be able to make it work.
True. Mm-hmm. That's true.
So that's why I say it's very situational.
That.
But the problem is there's no way to mitigate it. Like, how do you make sure people don't abuse it? You know what I mean?
Well, I don't know. That's how. Like anything.
You
got
to look at the situation because you can't just, it's hard to just generalize it. You're going to say, well, if a woman makes this X amount or she's at a stay, she's deserving to this
well, you know,
amount.
Every situation's different, right? Everyone's temperament is different. So,
well, how do the rich people do it?
Make it?
The rich people just do it.
Because they're rich, they don't give a fuck.
They just do it. It's not a matter of, you know what I mean? Like, this is what she needs.
Because we were talking
like, here,
in a
check.
Rich person's perspective.
Correct. Like, just if you're in an advantage where you're killing it, right?
But okay, there's different types of rich people though, because there's stingy people that they have a certain mentality, like where okay,
rich.
They have a mentality where it's like I save most of my money, and like my wife will only get like an allowance, and it's a small allowance. And then there's men that are like, anything that my woman wants to do, I'm gonna fund it. Like, just tell me what you want to do. Just like, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So there's
it differs.
It depends.
So much.
I feel like if this is something that's going to court, it would have to be like both people would have to be interviewed, and then you would have to just like how they bring CPS to your door and all this shit, and they investigate when it comes to like the
So let me give you a better question. What advice would you give a person that's ahead dating someone that's maybe not as quote unquote ahead financially? What would you tell them to do?
What would you
get
tell
your,
Kanye
get
West?
Your shit together first? And this is just from experience, like
okay,
because I know the type of person I am in a relationship. I will prioritize the other person more than myself sometimes.
Yeah.
And then in doing like in supporting and being like that because I believe in that person, I'll put myself to the side, and then when it's actually time to like address my shit, I don't even have the energy anymore. Because so it's
yeah,
like
you got to be the type of person to get your own shit together and then be in a relationship kind of.
I did this thing where it's like right before I got into a relationship, I told myself based on like seeing everybody else's situations and stuff and observing, I'm like, I don't want to get into that situation. So I told myself I need to get my shit together. I need to have my own car, own crib or whatever, mm-hmm. so that I'm not dependent on anybody else. That way when I do come into relationship, money is not the number one stressor in the relationship, which causes a lot of issues.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, that's not going to be an issue. We'll have other issues to address, right?
Yeah.
But I went against my own, like, agreement with myself and got into a relationship and saw exactly why the fuck I made that agreement in the first place. So, and here I am, like, a few relationships later, and I still feel like I should have got my shit together first because it would have been a lot better. But I feel like at the same time, it still depends on your part. Like it's situational. It depends on your partner, because I've had a lot of unsupportive, I feel like a little bit more narcissistic partners. And then now I feel like I have a partner that actually supports me and that's actually genuinely helping me. So I don't feel as bad about being in my situation as I would have when I was in the other situation.
Would it be this guy right here?
Yes.
Hey, shout out to that boy over there.
Get the air horns going.
Whoever he is, he's a lucky man out there and just very, very much.
So.
Damn, no goddamn. Okay.
No, I did. You missed it. You were talking over it.
Yeah. No, I heard it. I was just like, love you very much. At least like, goddamn. Oh,
bro, you can only do one at a time.
Oh, yeah, okay. Bro, you can't do it. You're obviously.
All right, so in the comments, we're looking for sound producers. So please, desperately.
I'll pay you out of pocket. You guys, this shit has been super fucking fun, man. So put in the comment sections everything that we asked you guys to do. Thank you for listening to us in this fucking crazy ass.
It was a great episode, by the way.
And this crazy ass Negro who just couldn't.
Welcome to the Rabbit Hole podcast.
Hey, Brandon, do you mind if I put it out there? Huh? If you're going to name this podcast, what would you name it?
The Rabbit
Hole. Put it in the comments right now.
The Rabbit Hole.
Put it in the rabbit. Put it.